Sales open Easter Sunday from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. Shop in person, 10939 Atlantic Boulevard, and online at arlingtontoyota.com.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Coogan Nation. Time to rise and shine and start your day with Duval Sports Media Big Steppers. Dan Hicken.
You know it!
Jeff Proctor.
It's a big deal.
Gosh, it sure is a big deal.
And E to the T.
E.T. is in the booth.
Rise and shine. Guggen's Go Time on a Friday morning. It's a GFL Friday. Yeah. Morning, E.T.
What they do, Jeffrey?
I want you to take a look. Take a look into these eyes, my brother. You see these eyes. Hold on. Is the YouTube up and running over there?
Oh, that YouTube is up and running, my boy.
Go over to the YouTube camera real quick.
I'm
going to walk over there. I want to ask you.
Yeah.
Whoever's out there streaming, yeah. Twitch, Roku. Apple TV Plus, I think we're on now.
You don't forget the Prime.
Okay. I want you to take a deep look into these eyes. Stand
those
by.
Eyes. Those eyes.
You know what that is?
What's that?
You know what those eyes are?
Beautiful blue eyes, if you ask
deep,
me.
Deep, sad, sleepy, depressed eyes. That's what you just got right there. Not baby blues. Nothing sparkling about them. Tired, sleepy, borderline grumpy, sad, hates basketball, depressed eyes. That's what those are. You know what eyes also are, ironically? You know what the shape of your eye is?
An oval.
Same shape as a wheel. My pupil right now may as well be a wheel. With just a cascade of negative consequence flowing over.
Oh dear.
Yeah. Not a good night, man. It opened up for me, and then it just slammed to shut. I went from feeling like, okay, I got a seam here. Let's hit the hole. Then I'm that running back that you see sometimes from behind. He's there, and there's a hole wide open to the left, and instead he just runs it up the guard's rear end on the right side of the line.
Yep.
That's me. Operation butt crack, buddy. Right up the line. Arizona loses. I need that. These two jokers got Arizona to the four. Okay, yeah. It opens up. I got Silly Man in there. He's taking Alabama to beat North Carolina. UConn just keeps rolling. UConn's winning it all, so it doesn't matter how much I fight back. Houston is not beating UConn for the championship. But it's stay alive, the survival game. So UConn is advanced. I got Arizona's bitten the dust. Both of these jabronis got Arizona into the four.
Ooh, jabroni.
Yes, sir. I got North Carolina here. Let's go. I mean, Florida beat Alabama twice. Nice job, Carolina. Riding you jokers. Nice job, you basketball elitists. Take your Carolina blue jerseys and wipe up my puke this morning. I puke on your program. Tobacco Road. High as a kite, baby. God, Bama. Come on, man. Bama's been losing to good teams all year. Nice job, Carolina Blue. Bastages. So after the early games, we all get UConn, well, there you go. He's up to 52. Dan's up to 46. Hey, I cracked the 40-point mark. Look at me. And now I'm set up gold, baby. I'm set up. I got Carolina now. It's opened up. These guys took Arizona. I'm going to fight and scratch and claw my way back in. Oh, by the way, E and I have Iowa State. Dan's got Illinois. I can make up another 3 points here. Let's go. And I fell asleep about halftime of the Alabama game, and I woke up, and I just got smashed right in these sad blue eyes because both Iowa State and North Carolina lose, which leads us to an updated leaderboard here. ET with 52.
Oh, yeah.
Dan. Oh, wait. Dan had, it was 49, 43, 37. Is that what it was?
I believe so. Yeah.
So Dan goes up to 49 with the Illinois win that we both missed. And I sit there at 40. 52, 49, 40. We running out of games, man. Deep, dark, depressed, sleepy, too. Sleepy eyes. Darn you, March Madness. It's going to take a heck of a comeback. It's a good day to declare my comeback. The greatest comeback story in the history of mankind played out this weekend. So let's go. You feel me? Happy Good Friday, everyone. Enjoy your Easter weekend. And for a large percentage who make it into the house of God a couple times a year, Easter being one of them, maybe something will take this year, right? We'll see you again in a month, huh? Next week, even. Anyway, I digress. That's the story. Here's the reality, E. As painful and as glaring as last night seemed, the missed opportunity that's there, at the end of the day, I got to have this other side of the bracket run out anyway. You see what I'm saying? So technically, by the math, and I've done it, I'm not dead yet. I'm not dead yet, but I'm dead.
These eyes.
This.
Cry every night.
They do, boy.
For you. These arms.
Punch myself in the face with these arms. That's what I want to do. I'm not holding anything but despair. Who's you? Despair? Come here, despair. Give me a hug. So, yeah, man, I thought I was, look, I'm the smart guy. I've seen Carolina down the stretch. I've watched them beat Duke. I mean, well, let's roll, baby. This thing is open up. I've watched Alabama. Every time they play a good team, they get walloped, unless they're at home. Whew, what an upset. Good job by Nate Oates and the boys. And there's the SEC. There's one in the Elite Eight. We'll see how Tennessee does against Creighton. I'll make this about me because I have the floor. Bottom line is I need Tennessee to win through their bracket and go to the Final Four, and I need Houston to win it all. And if I do that, I will not spin the wheel. No matter what happens anywhere else in the bracket, I need Tennessee to win their way to the Final Four, and I need Houston to win it all. I at least have hope.
That would be a crazy comeback.
I mean, to be honest with you, even if North Carolina had stayed alive, I'm not catching you slash y'all unless that happens. Doesn't feel that way this morning. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not catching you unless that happens anyway. Even if I get an extra 4 points from North Carolina, or had I gotten an extra 3, 4, 7, I'd still be down 5. I don't know. I lost a little bit of wiggle room. Let me take that back. The bottom line, though, is this. You and Hicken are sitting with UConn in that final, and there doesn't seem like a sure bet in sports right now that the UConn Huskies are going to repeat. We mentioned earlier this week, I don't know if we've given it enough due. UConn won every tournament game last year by double digits. They came out this tourney in the first two rounds, just a backhand and then a forehand and then smashing their way into the Sweet 16. They faced the team that they played in the national championship game last year.
San Diego State, right?
San Diego State. Yeah. Now, granted, it was a kind of a miraculous run for San Diego State. But here's UConn matched up with a team that went all the way to the final last year. They're a 5 seed. They're in the Sweet 16, and they beat them by 30.
Give me that powder.
30. So, Illinois, good luck. I could use you. I could use you. Truth is, I really don't trust Tennessee at all. I can see them losing to Creighton. And if that happens, my guy, he's just Fat City. That'll do it. That really, it does come down to this. If Creighton beats Tennessee, I'm done. Yeah, I'm out. I'm spinning. Oh, it's been a while since I've spun that wheel. Yeah, I didn't want to mush it. I have not spun that wheel. I mean, Hickens lost about 5, 6 of these bad boys in a row, man.
Yeah.
Various things, you know, bracket picks and football fix, Friday 5-packs and... I haven't had a spin in a while, man. I think the last time I had a spin was the pee pants. And that was the March Madness bracket probably 2 years ago. What has happened? I used to always win March Madness. Got to start watching more sports and stop watching, you know, The Night Agent on Netflix.
Get off of YouTube and watch the golf, man.
I do have Scottie Scheffler, at least. That's in the story for another day. Yeah, it comes down to that's what it is for me. Now, y'all got your own ways. It's simple as if Creighton wins even their next game, I'm almost positive you're safe.
Look at him. He's just jiving his shoulders in there.
Safe.
He's safe. Safe at the place. So, yeah, 52-49-40, and I'm the only one with Tennessee down there, and I'm the only one with Houston winning. It's the only thing right now that's saving me. I don't trust Tennessee as far as I can throw them. If they lost to Creighton tonight, it wouldn't surprise me, and I definitely don't think they're beating Purdue. Who's Purdue got? What ne'er-do-well is going to take their crack at the number one seed? That's what I need. I need whoever Purdue's playing to get busy tonight. I love how
Gonzaga?
Yeah, Purdue plays the Zags, yeah. Yeah, I mean, Gonzaga's got a fighting chance, right?
Gonzaga, yeah,
here's a little fact for you. Gonzaga Purdue played in the early season out in Hawaii, and Gonzaga led by 5 at the half, ended up losing the game, but 27-7, red hot, tourney tested. Maybe I can get the Zags to beat Purdue tonight. But what I think will really happen is I'll stay up. My silly self will be up at about 1 in the morning when Creighton, Tennessee come to conclusion with Creighton hitting their 27th three of the night to win by 3. And then it'll be over. The dream will be dead. It'll ruin my weekend. Holiday weekend and all. So anyway, that's how it played out last night. The madness ensued. Remember those ones and twos? Yeah, not so much. The one in the West region, North Carolina, loses to Alabama 89-87, perhaps while you were sleeping last night. So Roll Tide. The two, Arizona, upset by Clemson. So we have what looks more like a football playoff matchup. It'll be Alabama and Clemson with the winner going to the Final Four. Wow.
First time for either team too, right?
Final Four? That's good. Yeah, I bet it is. Yeah. Did you see that stat somewhere in the last 24 hours? Yeah, that makes sense. You got Tennessee, another team in that category. Yeah, I guess you're right. I heard a benchmark date for Clemson being 1980. That must be Elite Eight. So yeah, both these programs and one of them is gonna crack that. But again, it's a matchup that we're more accustomed to on the football field, right? Alabama and Clemson still alive. UConn rolls, and then the other two seed, Iowa State, they're out. So remember all those ones and twos in the Sweet 16 for the first time? Yeah, not so much. They gone. I think the thing I hate the most about the bracket. And I can't do it now. I'll never do it because of the job that we have and this little contest that we do. I'll never not pick a bracket. I wonder what it feels like to watch March Madness if you don't have a bracket.
Right.
Like, I'd be rooting for Alabama all day long. That would have been a fun watch for me if I'm not bound to this stupid bracket. You know what I mean? And that happens a lot over the course of your bracket in the early rounds where who you'd really like to see win, who you'd really be rooting for, you don't because – oh, my gosh, you got to protect the sanctity of that godforsaken bracket. All right, Major League Baseball's opening day yesterday for everyone but the Braves and Mets, and I guess by proxy, Brewers and Phillies. I did end up watching a lot of baseball yesterday. Apparently, it was still opening day, even though my Bravos didn't take the field and won't until this afternoon against the Phillies. Spencer Strider will take the mound there against Zach Wheeler. So that is a heck of a matchup on the pitcher's mound. We had drama yesterday. Juan Soto in his first game with the Yankees, he threw out a potential tying run at the plate in the ninth inning. The Orioles, who are everyone's darling, they were the first team to take the field yesterday. Mike Trout homered in his first at-bat for the Angels, but then Baltimore stormed back. Corbin Burns, their new ace, was outstanding. Struck out 11 in 6 innings. Orioles win easy. The Dodgers super team flexing its muscles yesterday. Shohei Ohtani on base 3 times in a row. Mookie Betts and Freddie Freeman both homered. So the MVP3 looked like it. So after starting 1-1 against the Padres, Dodgers bombed the Cardinals yesterday. I think it was 7-1. Always have interesting storylines and players making their mark and Unfortunately, yesterday we had some injury situations. The defending World Series teams, the Diamondbacks and the Rangers, both impressive in their openings. The Diamondbacks exploded in the third inning against the Rockies. They scored 14 runs. It's the fourth most for a team in a single inning since 1900. It's the most in an inning ever on opening day. So they scored 14 in an inning and beat the Rockies. Meanwhile, the Rangers beat the Cubs last night, so the defending World Series champs. Those are some of the winners from opening day. It didn't go so well for some others. We'll parse through opening day and really with excitement now look forward to today, particularly if you're a Braves fan, so they'll get going. Boy, I have an interesting list in front of me with the percolating landscape in college football and all of the realignment that has already occurred and that which may still occur. There was a guy put in all the numbers. He factored in all the factors, TV revenue, on-field success. It's like 20 different parameters. And then he ranked the attractiveness slash value of every FBS team if they were, say, to be drafted in a realignment pool. Say the TV network, CBS got to draft their group, ESPN got to grab their group. In other words, everything that a program brings to the table as a football program. And then kind of set the landscape from the team that will be most desirable down to 131 or whatever we are in FBS. Sorry, North Texas or whoever you're going to end up being. But it's surprising. Some programs are like they're like a can of corn. You can put them on a store shelf in 2002 and you could open them up in 2025 and they're still okay. Other brand names are perishable items, and teams that at one point held this great stature and seem to have lost it, and they're not still as attractive or viable as you might think. So, because it's just a football list. Because as I'm looking at this list, the attractiveness of, well, every program. If you just ranked every program by its attractiveness, if you're throwing together a new conference or a new realignment, I was surprised at the way the list played out. I'm not going to lie to you, and I'm going to go through that list. It's interesting. Got a couple more. Doug Peterson from his week at the owners' meetings. I think there's still a couple other storylines that we haven't really dug into. We'll share a couple of those when we come back on the other side. Phil Sims was into the night last night. So he's got a perspective on the Jaguars. Sims, of course, sits in that CBS studio. They are primarily focused on the AFC. So with his finger on the pulse of our franchise, I think pretty knowledgeable in the situation and certainly a big national name. You'll hear from him. So going to hear from Phil Sims coming up next segment as well. We'll talk to Captain Kev, see what's happening out in the water. We're up and rolling on a sad-eyed GFL Friday. You're listening to The Drill on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. 1010XL. Home of the Florida Gators.
Now at Hodges Mazda, take advantage of 0% APR on a new 2024 Mazda SUV. Lauren Brooks here. Choose from the off-road ready 2024 Mazda CX-50 or go in style in a 2024 Mazda CX-30. With 0% APR for 36 months, you choose the Mazda CX-30 or Mazda CX-50 to drive away in. Our professional non-commissioned sales team always puts your best interests first. Plus, every vehicle purchase comes with 2 years free maintenance. Visit us today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com for the Hodges Mazda difference. See dealer for details, terms, fees for qualified applicants expires April 1st, 2024.
Seminole Hard Rock Tampa is excited to bring you live craps, roulette, and sports betting. All under one roof, hotter than the Florida sun. Feel the luck of the dice, watch the roulette wheel spin, and scream for your touchdown as the big screen comes alive. Dine like a rock star, sip cocktails that shimmer, then dive into the heart of Las Vegas right here in Tampa Bay. Live craps, roulette, sports betting is here. Get in on the action now. Only at Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Tampa, located off of I-4 near I-75. Gambling problem? Call 1-888-ADMINUTE.
Imagine the perfect outdoor living space. A beautiful stone kitchen, waterfall, fire pit, pergola, stone walkway. Now there's one place to bring all of your design ideas to life. The Art of Natural Stone on Beach Boulevard and also by Bartram Springs.
A lot of companies will tell you they're the best. At Custom Tree Surgeons, they show you every time. Custom Tree Surgeons has built an all-pro team. Every tree service professional has years of experience, continually trained and certified. They know what, when, and how to handle any job. It gets done efficiently and quickly by a team of experts. So for tree trimming, removal, stump grinding, and emergency services, forget any name other than Custom Tree Surgeons. There is no job they can't do better. Go to website, CustomTreeSurgeons.com. That's CustomTreeSurgeons.com. And let them show you how the job is supposed to get done.
In sports, the grind outside the lines is what ultimately defines our success. Get the Amateur's Edge, powered by B3 Better, to learn the hidden path of top pros, amateurs, and coaches. Saturday mornings at 11 on 1010XL.
Let me get this thing unwrapped here.
Duval! Proz, what in the world are you doing working on your Duval?
That's right. Man, I really identify with Duval.
You live in St. John's County, knucklehead.
I mean the Duval sub, the Daily's Dash Duval. Turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheeses. Lettuce, tomato, crispy and fresh, you know, like me. I'm sure there's a Daily's Dash sub that sums you up.
The boss.
Because, of course,
oven-roasted beef, Munster cheese, roasted mushrooms, caramelized onions. It's the boss of all subs. Only available for me.
That's just not true.
What do you mean? I walked in the other day, screamed, "You know it!" and said, "A boss for a boss!"
Well, no matter who you are, there is a Daily's Dash sandwich or sub for you.
Go find yours. They may even make you a boss.
I'm sure they will, because it is Daily's Dash.
Where more is better.
And you got that right.
After consulting with several orthopedic specialists about my constant knee pain, I chose Southeast Orthopedic Specialist and Dr. Chris Swanson to handle my surgery. Their professionalism let me know this team was the one for me. The surgery was very successful, and if I ever have a future knee, I'll continue to trust Southeast Orthopedic Specialists to take care of me.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Mia here, and let me tell you about one of our area's best resorts, the Sawgrass Marriott Golf Resort and Spa. The Sawgrass Marriott is not only a great destination for a vacation, but it is also a great destination for dining on the Florida's first coast. 1912 Ocean Bar and Rooftop is now open on Ponte Vedra Boulevard, featuring Ponte Vedra's only oceanfront rooftop bar and lounge. Serving finely crafted cocktails and delectable eats, it's open daily from 4 to 10 with complimentary valet parking.
This is Hayes Carlion for Skylife Elite. Have you ever thought about aircraft ownership as another potential revenue stream and as a tool for tax savings? Put your tax money to work for you while enjoying the benefits of private personal travel. Skylife Elite has over a decade of experience in business aviation and can guide you through the process with their expert staff. Call my friends over at Skylife Elite at 490-9332 or find them at flyskylife.com to get the rundown on everything owning an airplane can do for you.
Frank Frangie here. I was born and raised in Jacksonville, and I love living here. But I also know how bad bugs are in Florida. So I trust Orange Environmental Services to handle all my pest control needs because they've got the best technicians and effective treatment. Their name may be Orange, but they think green. Orange Environmental has been serving the First Coast for over 50 years, and they now offer complete lawn maintenance services. Call Orange Environmental Services for peace of mind from bug problems today. Call them at 272-3284. That's 272-3284.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. 120,000 miles of night drives, daily commutes, and who knows how many.
Are we there yet?
Through countless fixes, elbow grease, and a new radiator, you kept your ride alive. With eBay Motors, you have over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus, at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Open early and open late. Daly's is always there, making things easy for you to cruise in and cruise out. So hit Daly's Cold Case the next time you're craving a cold one. Bud Light by the case. Plus plenty of singles to choose from. Corona to the King of Beers to Stella or a Natty. They're all cold at Daly's.
Zone 10XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Now, Captain Kevin Favors' fishing report on 1010XL.
All right, let's fire up that All-Pro Roofing Hotline. Bring in my buddy, Captain Kevin Favor. Going to fill us in what's happening out there on the waterways. Kev, I was listening to you guys a couple. I got into a conversation with Mrs. P about our favorite fish. Right? You know, your favorite fish to eat. And sure. I was listening to y'all, I don't know, a couple weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, and you guys on the panel there on the outdoor show, you went through your three favorite fish to eat. It was either three or five. I think it was three. And your list surprised me.
Okay, why is that?
I don't know. I can't remember what. Did sea bass maybe show up? What were your three? Do you remember? Here's the great thing. I bet you can give me three right now, and it won't match the three you gave 3 weeks ago.
You're absolutely right. So I'll give it to you in different order. But sheep's head. You know, black drum, snook, sea bass, triggerfish.
Yeah. I didn't hear a couple that I thought it would. Maybe that's why. Like, I didn't hear wahoo. I thought you might throw that. I didn't hear cobia, which is
also
good. Cobia, I'm kind of getting over.
Cobia is great fried. You know, it's those big chunks.
Mm-hmm.
And wahoo. Is very good fresh, you know. But it's one of those almost. If you vacuum seal it, which is what we do, it's good for 2 or 3 months. But it's still nothing
get to it
like
quick.
And by the way, you know, a wahoo, a 50-pound wahoo. That's 35 pounds of meat.
You know, time for fish fry. Yeah.
It's not like you're eating all that. I'm more of a, you know, an inshore.
I've never had sheep's head.
Listen,
that's great. I've heard it's good. She has.
It's absolutely the best.
Yeah.
It really is. If I get on a bite at some point in time this spring, I'll certainly save you some.
My field of vision when it comes to what I'll eat has really grown a lot lately. And we're getting some votes on the Texan Design by Lifetime Enclosures. Cobia, sea bass, don't laugh, bluegill. Now we're talking about ocean fish. Bluegill is a very underrated, tasty little fish. Now you got to eat around some bones.
It's absolutely love it. But we are and I've had this conversation. We're so spoiled. Give me that big old, you know, fillet of a 5 pound sheep's head
for
doesn't
sure.
have any bones in it, you know. Yeah.
Mr. Ten goes grouper, cobia, snapper.
Snapper. Way down for me.
Yeah.
I'm not a big snapper fan at all.
I like grouper. Now, grouper's good.
Grouper's good. We just don't catch them.
I've never eaten sea bass either. I've never had sea bass or. But like I said, I was going to say, I'm just started. Varying. Usually, if I went to seafood, I had fried shrimp a thousand times to one per visit. I'd never get anything but.
Right. Well, I get it. But a sea bass is wonderful. The white, flaky meat.
I'm going to have some of that.
You will love sea bass. And you can cook it however you want.
I'm not sure that my favorite isn't perfectly fried triggerfish. I think that might be my favorite.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Triggerfish is definitely top five.
Yeah, it's showing up now on menus a lot more, too. It's funny how that kind of ebbs and flows.
It does. Yeah. It does. You'll find that, you know, that's, like I said, it's with the grouper thing, you just don't see it very much because we don't catch that many anymore. And by the way, the regs really get ready to get stricter on the grouper.
Really?
Which they should. I mean, it's, you know, again, outdoorsmen always regulate ourselves because of what we see. You know what I mean? And I haven't caught a legal grouper in years.
Wow.
And I mean years. And I do a lot of bottom fishing, buddy. And, you know, it used to be, you know, come November when the water cooled off, we would go grouper fishing. They would move in, you know, to those, you know, 8, 9, 10 miles offshore wrecks and stuff, and that just doesn't happen anymore.
I've caught on some of the mahi trips that don't go great in the stream, and we'll stop, like you said, 8, 10 miles out, and we've caught keepable grouper, but that's been, you know, that's probably been 15 years, maybe.
Exactly. It's been 15, 17 years.
We're getting a couple of people that are shouting out a fish that I don't even know what this fish is, but on the text line, there more than one are saying hogfish.
Hogfish, yeah, that's a snapper.
Oh, that's a snapper. Okay, yeah.
Yep. It's an ugly looking snapper, but it is in the snapper family.
Hogfish is the best. Another one I can't believe nobody says hogfish is my favorite by a good amount. Anyway, I've never heard it called hogfish.
And the reason we're probably not saying that is because we don't get very many of them here.
I got you. And everything else we do, it seems like. I tell you, another one I've not eaten, pompano. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go through. My goal here is,
here's the deal. I'm not big on pompano at all.
Okay, I hear people talk about it.
Yeah, they talk about it like it's a delicatessen.
It looks like it would be oily to me.
It's a little oily, but it's just a different texture. And by the way, some people just absolutely love it. I mean,
I've heard that, and I'm not big on it at all. Doesn't look like just the way they're shaped, and I've caught some decent size, so it doesn't look like they'd have very big fillets on them either. But that sometimes
you get a 2.5 pounder.
Oh, okay,
it's a thick fillet.
Yeah, I've not caught one that big.
Very, very thick fillet.
All right, so what's the best bet if we're going to go out and find some fish this weekend?
Well, the first thing is that the weather has really messed with the fish and the fishermen this week. It's been, you know, raining one day, and then wind's blowing the next day. It's cold one day, and then it's hot, you know, and we have to have some stable weather, and it looks like we're going to have that tomorrow. I guess half the fleet of the Wahoo shootouts going out because it is the last day, and they're only calling for southwest at 5 to 10 tomorrow. So it's going to be wide open with what you want to do, and then Sunday's supposed to even be better, southwest at 5. So a couple things: if you're itching to run the beach, you know, maybe find a bait pod or even if you want to fish some of the near shore wrecks for sheep's head and black drum and yellowmouth trout and stuff like that, going to be a great weekend for that. If you want to get away from the crowd of the inshore, because I think that with the inshore fishing is going to be very good. It's been a little slow this week, but it's been due to the weather. It hasn't been due to the fish not being there, and it looks like it's just going to be, I mean, like a beautiful weekend. So. Looking forward to it.
Yeah. Well, sounds great. Outdoor show tomorrow?
Outdoor show tomorrow, absolutely.
Okay. Well, have a great week, and we'll talk to you next week, and have a happy Easter to you and the family.
You too, buddy. Have a great weekend.
Thank you, man. There he goes. That's Captain Kevin Favor, All-Pro Roofing Hotline, best in the business, even giving us his culinary preferences this morning. Listen, there is going to be, I promise you, every effort – every opportunity given to two players on this Jaguars football team, two second-year players, more maybe than any other players on the roster. There will be an insistence on two players getting much more opportunity this year than they did last year. That's evident by the code word onboarding that Trent Baalke has used in describing parts of the roster when it comes to development. I spoke to there could be a growing rift between front office and coaching staff if they can't get in alignment with what the scouting side is drafting and giving based on how they think and what they think is going to be used, then it has to be thought and used the way you're giving them that impression. And I think there is some disconnect by the drafting of Brenton Strange and Tank Bigsby last year and the relative amount of, relative lack, I should say, of opportunity for those dudes. So I promise you, it doesn't look contentious, and they're on the same page, but Trent Baalke's passing the buck here a little bit of, well, we didn't develop our players. We draft, you know, I'm saying this publicly, but it's like, hey, you said you need this, this, and this. We draft this, this, and this, and then you go in a different direction. And I don't know that to be the truth. I know that to be kind of the feeling within the organization. They're not on the same page. That's clear by how the draft class was not used a year ago. So I promise you, they're going to be a concentrated effort, especially early, to get Brenton Strange and Tank Bigsby involved with this offense. Peterson set the table a little bit at the owners' meetings when he talked about Evan Engram and how he could be used a lot more this year as a deep threat and more of a wide-out position, even though he's a tight end, which means more opportunity, certainly more playing time, more, quote, onboarding for a guy who was a second-round pick last year. If you draft a tight end in the second round, everyone gets more production out of that pick than the Jaguars got last year. I mean, don't kid yourself. Look around the league at every rookie tight end, and I bet you Brenton Strange's production numbers, I don't know how many deep in the tight ends you got to go. He's probably last of the first 10 tight ends to go up, but they all had more production. So I promise you, there's going to be an insistence on more Brenton Strange.
Yeah, you know, it is and it will. You know, and Brenton's another young tight end that we got to find ways to get on the field and create some matchups. We like what he did last year for us, and we can now we can build upon that. And I think that tight end room is a strong room, even with Luke. You know, with Luke in there, there's depth and there's stability, which you got to have.
All right, so there's one side. He also said down at the owners' meetings they got to be better in the run game. That may be an O-line thing as much as anything. But the 2 years in a row, they've drafted backs to take some of the pressure off Travis Etienne. And 2 years in a row, none of that pressure has been relieved. He's still carrying the ball way too high a percentage. He's getting too many touches. You know, it showed. He suffered with some banged up and some lingering injuries. They got to get more out of the running game. They got to get more out of Tank Bigsby. You can't go fourth-round running back 1 year, third-round running back the next year, and then combine the two totals and not get to 200 yards. So Peterson, on another second-year player, who I would suspect is going to get fed. Assuming, by the way, that they don't reach back into the draft. Can we go third or fourth round on a back again? No. Got to get it right. Got to get him on the field. Got to be productive. Here's Doug Peterson on Tank Bigsby.
We got to get Tank going. I mean, bottom line, he's too good. That's why we drafted him, you know. I think early he had some bad – just those, whoa, what is that type play, you know, for whatever reason, right or wrong. And then again, it was just in and out of the lineup. But he is a young player that we're excited about. Definitely, as we talked about last year, we can take some burden off of ETN a little bit, you know, keep him healthy for the remainder of the season.
Yeah, that's a song they've been singing for a year and a half. We'll see. Injuries so much a part of the storyline in the collapse last year, but injuries are also so much of a part of the storyline of every NFL season. And part of the Jags' success 2 years ago is that they stayed relatively healthy. Go back to the last good season. It was the same storyline, wasn't it? In 17, they stayed healthy. Remember, they didn't lose anybody to injury games. Well, that's not how it works in the NFL. You got to build quality depth. Look what happened to the Bills last year. They're losing dudes left and right. They still managed to rally and get their footing. And now they, you know, obviously finally got the Chiefs at home. Couldn't beat them. But anywho, you'll hear from Phil Simms on Trevor Lawrence when we come back with a football fix. Also, pro day workouts yesterday. These two dudes are kind of the wild cards, right? The attention is on Caleb Williams and Jaden Daniels more than the other guys. Is that fair? Right? Those are the two that are going to go 1 and 2, 1, you know, one way or the other. And then there's that next group, of guys, and it includes now J.J. McCarthy's on the rise, Bo Nix is on the rise, and then two of the other dudes were worked out yesterday. I don't think there's a more polarizing prospect than Drake May, who some put up there in the, you know, top two, and then there are others that have them, you know, further down the board. I think what ends up happening between Nix, May, McCarthy, one of them will fall further than you think they should. Like one may go higher than you think they should. One of them will tumble down into the teens. And I don't know if that's really a tumble, by the way, for either Bo Nix or or J.J. McCarthy. But McCarthy, arrow pointing up, buddy. They seem to be feeling his groove of late. March Madness rolls on. Big-time upsets last night. We'll talk a lot about that as we go through the morning. We had Major League Baseball's opening day. Sadly, minus four teams. But the Braves scheduled to get on the sked today. Same with the Mets at home against the Brewers. Those are the four teams, Braves, Phillies, Mets, Brewers, who weren't able to go on opening day. I would put the percentage chances on my Atlanta Hawks surviving through the play-in and grabbing either the 7 or the 8 seed. I guess it will be the 8 seed, the best they could do, and grabbing the 8 seed in the Eastern Conference playoffs. I'd say their chances of doing that are very low. I'd say their chances of beating the Bulls in the 9-10 game, it's definitely going to be those two, and then beating most likely the winner, the loser of the Sixers Heat game, probably on their home floor. I'd say the chances of the Hawks doing that and advancing into the 8-team bracket are very low. But if they do, you see us, Boston Celtics. You see us. A 30-point deficit overcome two nights ago by the Hawks hosting the Celtics. They led Atlanta by 30. Atlanta came back and won. We told you in the last 25 years, Celtics not blown a lead that big. The Hawks have not blown a lead that big. The history of the league, that the teams in that situation are like 6 and 3,200 and something. It's just a ridiculous number. And so, lo and behold, they run it back again last night in Atlanta. And in overtime, it's the Hawks 123 and the Celtics 122. You don't want us as that 8 seed, Boston. You don't want none of this Atlanta smoke. We're back with Phil Simms on Trevor and a Football Fix. You're listening to The Drill. It's a GFL Friday on 1010XL.
The Drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
This is Brent Musburger's VSiN Action Update on 1010XL. Brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Spencer Strider on the mound for the Atlanta Braves today at Philadelphia. After yesterday's washout, it's opening day for the Braves. They're the number 25 favorite. Zach Wheeler for the Phillies, a plus 105 underdog. Toronto plus 102 at Tampa Bay today. Aaron Civale pitching for the Rays, minus 122, 8 under at Tropicana Field. Denny Hamlin, Christopher Bell, the 5-1 co-favorites to win the Toyota Owners 400 at Richmond on Sunday. Martin Truex Jr. is 6-1. Toyota, the top manufacturer at minus 120, Chevrolet plus 240, Ford 3-1. Sign up for the free VSiN newsletter and keep up to date with the biggest sports betting news and insights only at VSIN.com. With your action update, Mike Sennett, 1010XL.
Duck Duck Rooter is a full-service plumbing company that's locally owned and operated, fully licensed and insured. We'll be at your home in a timely manner, provide honest pricing, and ensure the job is completed correctly or we'll make it right. Duck Duck Rooter can handle all plumbing jobs, including repairing broken pipes, clearing clogged drains, to installing new fixtures, water heaters, garbage disposals, and full repipes for older homes. If you're stuck, call the Duck, 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
When it's time for the March Mania brackets to bust wide open. As I was saying, it's mad. The Mania of March at BetUS.com is all about those buzzer beat bonus offers. And when the madness starts and Cinderella man steps onto the BetUS always has your back with back-to-back-to-back 125% sign-up bonuses on your first three deposits and even 10% gambler's insurance. BetUS.com Sportsbook and Casino, where the game... Join today. BetUS Sportsbook and Casino, where the game begins.
When you step into a courtroom, you're stepping into a fight. Someone wins, someone loses. I'm attorney Brett Hastings, and at Hastings Injury Law, we've got the experience you want in your corner if you or a loved one suffer a personal injury or a wrongful death. We're here to fight for you. So if you get hit, hit back with Hastings Injury Law, offices Jacksonville. Find us on the web at 904hitback.com or call our 24-hour helpline, 904-HITBACK.
Fish are good at hiding. Captain Kevin can help you find them.
Oh, yeah, that's a big one.
Find more fish on the Ring Power Fishing Forecast Show.
Thursday nights at 6.
Brought to you by Awaken 180 Weight Loss on 1010 XL AM.
Baloo here for Smunez Vision. Why Smunez Vision? Well, I've been with Dr. Neil Smunez now since I got back to Jacksonville in 2006. 37 years of experience he has. Smunez Vision is a family organization that focuses on personal high-quality medical and surgical eye care. Dr. Catherine Smunez is fellowship-trained in cornea and cataract surgery and all refractive surgery. Combined, that's 30 years plus in laser eye surgery. Visit SmunezVision.com today. Here you can see.
Big Chief Tire has been Jacksonville's trusted tire expert for over 60 years. Frank Frangie here. The new season is upon us, and they are here to ensure your journeys are smooth and worry-free. Gear up for any travel by scheduling service at one of their five locations. From tire rotations to custom wheels and more, the experts at Big Chief are here to ensure your vehicle is ready. Visit the website at BigChiefTire.com or call 904-932-0950 to schedule an appointment today.
Hi, I'm Sean Monahan from Monahan Jewelers in Atlantic Beach. Since 1977, we've been Jacksonville's family jeweler, where our true specialty is engagement rings and custom jewelry design. And now, buy your diamond engagement ring at Monahan's and get any diamond wedding band and men's wedding bands for 50% off. Come in and be treated like family for one of the most important purchases of your life. Buy your diamond engagement ring right now at Monahan's and get any diamond wedding band and gents band for 50% off. Come to Monahan Jewelers in Atlantic Beach or book an appointment at MonahanJewelry.com.
Are you a meat lover searching for quality cuts? Southern Steer Butcher uses a vacuum tumbler to marinate and tenderize our chicken and world-famous steak tips.
Now open in Ortega. For tasty tips and juicy breasts, choose Southern Steer Butcher.
Chose C for CSS Fireplaces and Outdoor Living. They can transform your backyard with fire pits, pergolas, screen enclosures, and outdoor kitchens. And CSS handles the entire project from start to finish. You dream it, they build it. CSSOutdoor.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, boaters and landlubbers, friends, four-legged and two, this is Lisa the Boatinista with a huge announcement. Freedom Boat Club is opening a brand new fourth location. That's right, Freedom Boat Club St. Augustine Shipyard is now open. Now members can enjoy unlimited access at Julington Creek, Jacksonville Beach, St. Augustine Comanche Cove, and St. Augustine Shipyard. Freedom Boat Club members also enjoy reciprocal access to over 400 locations across the world. There's never been a better time to join. We are offering our biggest discount ever to celebrate our brand new location. We own and maintain an entire fleet of boats. Join the club, and as often as you like, you can do water sports, inshore fishing, offshore fishing, sandbar hopping, dining on the water, or just cruising around town. Visit us at the St. Augustine Shipyard or stop by any of our locations to see what the Boatsierge experience is all about. Visit us at freedomboatclub.com.
This is Hayes Carline for First Florida Credit Union. I bank with First Florida Credit Union because I trust them. I can always count on them when it comes to the vast services they provide. First Florida Credit Union was voted Best Bank in the 2023 Best of Bold City Community Choice Awards, and it's easy to see why. I go to the branch off 210 in St. Johns County and the new Durbin location, but they have 10 branches in the Jacksonville area. You need to be banking with First Florida Credit Union. They're enriching people every day. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Opportunity Lender.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
All right, back on a TFL Friday. That's Green for Life. Look for these bright green trucks and cans all over the First Coast. I'm coming back with a Shazam spotlight. Shazam. Brought to you by the Burry Ford Superstore. Stark and Kingsland, take that short drive, beat these big city prices, and deal with my dude at the Murray Superstore, Stark and Kingsland. It's like this dude, Scottie Scheffler, is playing a video game with a cheat code at this stage. He doesn't lead after round one of Houston. Certainly looks like he's going to win again. It would be his third straight. He's just one shot back of Taylor Moore and some dude named Wilson Furr. Pretty sure over the next three rounds, Wilson Furr is not going to outpace Scottie Scheffler, who opened yesterday in Houston with a 65. But here's why it's the Shazam Spotlight. It's not just some generic Captain Obvious, hey, Scottie Scheffler's playing good. Scheffler yesterday played his 28th round of 2024, and for the 28th consecutive round, he scored under par. That sets a PGA Tour record that goes back to 1983. Not even Tiger. Not even Tiger, 28 rounds in a row, under par. So he's off the lead, but he's certainly in the driver's seat for what would be a third consecutive tour victory as they are in Houston. Then there's one more stop. I believe it's Valero in San Antonio. And then it's off to the Masters where Scheffler just stays on a heater. So here's my plan. My plan is to get Scheffler's first place money this week, tank next week to make sure that I get the first pick for the Masters, and then get all that cash for the Masters, and I can shoot all the way into first place. I need something after a sad, sleepy, dark, lonely, depressing night of March Madness hoops for your boy. All right, Trevor Lawrence's play last year. I did a little comparison yesterday, and it was pretty interesting. If you're thinking about a quarterback, ET, I know that you need consistency, but if you're talking about young quarterbacks, how long do you give for consistency? I got a comparison I'm going to drop a little bit later when Hicken gets here that I found was a little bit surprising. I don't know if it applies. I'm a Trevor stan. I'm an apologist. I find ways and numbers and routes and analytics to perhaps make him more emboldened than he should be or stand up to greater scrutiny than he might normally. But I think I can at least open some eyes to a big misconception or a bigger misconception that you hold that perhaps you didn't. So that's coming up. But there's no denying that Trevor and his progress is a league-wide interesting topic. Phil Simms of CBS Sports on End of the Night with our boy Hacker, what he wants to see from Trevor Lawrence in 2024.
Trevor Lawrence has a lot of great gifts, size, speed, really good arm, all this other stuff. But Doug Peterson, I'm sure, you know, I'm just going to say it my way, is that he expects more, better performance on the field, leading, you know, being a force in the team.
Of course, End of the Night's with Rick Ballew. I don't know what I'm looking at a mug of Hacker. Stop. Ballew won't like that, by the way. There's anybody at the station that you can, like, misidentify on something like that. It could be an email. Some people are a little different. Some people hit different. ET doesn't want to say anything, and they're like, at him. He's got a scrunch up face. That wasn't me. Look, here's a reality, too, now, and I don't think in these terms, like, part of what I use with Trevor is, like, we got to have some patience here, man. There's a lot of quarterbacks around the league, the greats in league history, had to wait, you know, 5, 6, 7, 10 years to win Super Bowls. I mean, Manning, you know, Peyton didn't win, I think, till year 7 or 8. Elway, year 12, 13. I mean, it takes a while, man. Longer than that, actually, for Elway. 15 years playing at a high level before he won. Matthew Stafford, years. But perhaps it's not the same game as it once was. Here's a former Super Bowl-winning quarterback himself, Phil Simms, on End of the Night with Rick Ballew on the time frame for showing that you're that guy.
The window to impress your team and to be the franchise quarterback big time, it's shorter than ever. It really is. The focus on NFL football, it's on two people, the quarterback and the coach. And the quarterback's number one, for sure. I'm in the business. Everybody wants to know about him. We're in the studio. We talk more about quarterbacks than anything else. That's where the league has kind of gone to. And like I said, a couple years, You kind of know what you got, where it's going, and you make your decisions earlier than past years.
So there you go. That's just another national voice on.
I'm a sausage guy.
Thank you. Yeah, it's End of the Night with Rick Ballew, of course, as you knew. Fire up the band. We got a football fix. Brought to you by your Jacksonville Sharks. See, we get a win this weekend at Vegas. Get back to 1-1 on the year, and the home opener is coming up April 6th, which is, what, next Friday? So, or next Saturday. E.T., part of the game day festivities down there. And the Sharks coming off a title-winning year. They're in a new league. It's going to be more competitive. There's some rules changes. We talked about that. But jacksharks.com, get your tickets today. Also, buy the home course. My friends at the Georgia Creek Golf Club, the best deal in golf. All right, so the polarizing quarterbacks worked out yesterday. Michael Penix Jr. showed off some speed that maybe we didn't know he had. He didn't look like the fastest dude, right? He doesn't. But he showed a dual threat to his overall abilities, unleashed a deep ball that went 75 yards in the air for a completion. So he showed off some arm talent. But the stat that may have surprised people more than any was a sub-4.6 40. According to the stopwatches that were there, Penix's lone run was, came between, you know, like a 4.56 and a 4.59. And Penix said afterward, I'm a 4.4 guy, in my opinion. He wasn't super happy with that. Drake May, also working out for the Scouts, big, strong, tall, in-the-pocket quarterback. That used to be the dream of our talent evaluators, but this athletic ability that's showing up in today's modern quarterback has kind of changed those parameters of a 6'5 statue. Going to be interested to see where May falls. What do these teams do with quarterback need? And how exactly do they sort? I mean, now I'm seeing some that teams are really want to get to four because Arizona's at three, right? They're going Marvin Harrison Jr. One and two are going to be Caleb Williams and Jaden Daniels. And so then, yeah, how much sorting do we see there near the top? Remember we had the story yesterday that the Jets owner Woody Johnson had gotten into a vehement argument with Robert Saleh at the owners' meetings, a quote, very heated conversation. Woody Johnson went to social media and rebutted that claim. By the way, it was the NFL Network that was reporting this. All this nonsense about a heated argument between Coach Saleh and me at the league meeting is absolutely false. It's yet another irresponsible report from NFL Network. Please disregard.
Oh, dear.
And that's family, right? NFL Network, you ain't calling out ESPN. The NFL Network's Colleen Wolf gained traction Wednesday when on Around the NFL, she said she heard about the alleged Johnson-Saleh dispute from a very reliable source. Initially, she said it occurred at the cocktail reception Monday night. Later, she said it was Sunday night, not Monday. Didn't go much more into detail, but said it became, quote, a little awkward. I'm waiting for him to call me from downtown. What is this dissension in the franchise? That's a lot. Coach Peterson and I are on the same page. Lockstep. These headlines never work, dude. I'm over this NFL team signing this rugby star, this NFL team signing this Australian football star. Stop it. But the Chiefs have signed rugby star Luis Rhys-Zammit. The European rugby star, in fact. Going to look at him at running back, maybe wide receiver. But get that new, you know, maybe find some of these rugby studs who are used to that big, jumbled, you know, mass of humanity for the new kickoff, maybe. New kickoff looks kind of like a rugby play. Rhys-Zammit is 23 years old. That's a football fix. You're welcome. Hick and Arrival and more come your way next. I got an awesome pop quiz from a very, very interesting list that I came across yesterday. So we'll do that a little bit later this morning. Some of your other Friday favorites. It's a GFL Friday. That's Green for Life. And we're back to welcome Friday to the show next.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Defense in Duval.
Another pick for that Jags. Terrific secondary.
1010XL.
Ball knocked out of there. And the Jags have it.
Home of the Jaguars.
Hey, folks, there are trucks, and then there's the truck, the GMC Sierra. With available features like the V8 engine, the ultimate luxury interior, and, of course, the available world's first six-function multi-pro tailgate, Nimnik Buick GMC has the largest inventory of GMC Sierras in Northeast Florida and Southeast Georgia. Now, this month, you can save up to $10,000 off select new GMC Sierra 1500s or enjoy rates as low as 2.9% APR financing.
Maybe you're looking for the perfect SUV. Well, you can save thousands on the popular GMC Terrain, plus rates as low as 0.9% APR for well-qualified buyers. And no payments for 90 days. You get it. You want a good SUV or a good truck, you want to head to Nimnik Buick GMC. That's Nimnik, your friends in the car business since 1941.
Hard Rock Bet presents Legal in Florida.
You can bet the game on Hard Rock Bet. No more betting inside your head.
A no-regret first bet up to $100 when you sign up now. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 and over and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMITTED.
Hey, gang. Hicken here. March is Workplace Eye Wellness Awareness Month. Here's a tip for those in front of a computer all day. Follow the 20-20-20 rule. Set a timer as a reminder to look 20 feet away every 20 minutes for 20 seconds. It could be as simple as looking away from your computer screen or out the window. If virtual meetings keep you in your seat for an extended time, shut your eyes for 20 seconds. And then call or visit BowNye.com to schedule your consultation. BowNye, they're keeping the first coast focused.
Top Dog Tavern is your gathering place for family and friends, offering something for everyone. Want a delicious meal served with a smile? We have you covered. Shareable appetizers, hot and crispy wings, juicy tavern burgers, fresh salads, plus a large craft beer selection. And there is nowhere better to watch all the big games than on our multiple TVs. Enjoy great food, cold drinks, and good times at Top Dog Tavern, located in Bartram Park off Old St. Augustine Road.
Are you embarrassed by your ugly, cracked concrete driveway? Need to enhance your home's curb appeal? StoneCore on Phillips Highway is your one-stop shop for all your outdoor needs. Replacing with new stone pavers will transform your driveway into a stunning work of art. Say goodbye to unsightly concrete and hello to beautiful, durable pavers that last for years. Visit StoneCore today and let's beautify your home together. StoneCore.co. We do outdoors better.
Lamb of God and Mastodon live. Celebrating 20 years of Ashes of the Wake and Leviathan. July 23rd, Daly's Place. With special guests, Kerry King and Malevolence. Lamb of God and Mastodon's Ashes of Leviathan Tour. Tickets on sale now at LiveNation.com.
Here's another remarkable success story from QC Kinetics. This one from Chad, who hurt his knee at the gym one day, and it just kept on hurting for months.
From my high school football and wrestling days, I already had a little bit of damage in there, but this just sent it over the edge.
Chad tried traditional treatments with no improvement when he turned to the non-surgical regenerative treatments at QC Kinetics.
It was really fascinating how they did their work, and the science behind it was very intriguing, and it works. Extracting the cure out of my own body blew my mind. It's like I'm brand new again. It was fantastic.
That's because the QC Kinetics natural biologic treatments use your body's own healing power to restore damaged tissue in your hips, shoulders, back, and knees, providing long-lasting relief.
Now I'm back at the gym. I'm 100%, feeling great.
If you're tired of suffering with pain from arthritis or injury, call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. 904-274-5522.
It's March basketball. That means a host of top teams will be competing for the NCAA title. When it comes to commercial painters, there's also some healthy competition out there. Jason Parker with Performance Painting. To help you know the right questions to ask any painter competing for your business this year, visit PerformancePaintingJax.com. Or if you're ready for a friendly quote, give us a call and ask about our free pressure wash promotion for your next project. Performance Painting, quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
Edwin Watts Golf Shops by Worldwide Golf. There's something that binds us all. The collective goal to transcend the ordinary. Introducing the all-new Ping G730 and I530 irons. The G730 irons are Ping's longest and most forgiving irons, while the I530s fit golfers who want more distance in a player's design and are engineered for higher launch and more. Visit us in-store at Edwin Watts Golf Shops or online at worldwidegolf.com. Get there.
the flagship station of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, sponsored by Southern Oak Insurance. Jacksonville Jaguars have dipped their toes in the tight end market. On Thursday, the Jaguars announced they've signed former Green Bay Packer tight end Josiah DeGuerra. He becomes the team's ninth outside free agent to sign. The Noles had another spring scrimmage on Thursday. Head coach Mike Norvell saw the defense stand out.
But the defense was really good, you know, for the majority of the scrimmage. I thought their speed and physicality, that definitely showed up. You know, some impactful plays.
It was opening day Thursday in Major League Baseball. Our in-state teams took the field. The Miami Marlins were edged out by the Pittsburgh Pirates in a game that went 12 innings. In the American League, the Toronto Blue Jays beat out the Tampa Bay Rays. That's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Sam Nelson.
It's 7:07 and it's 50 degrees. Your time and your temp is brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller. Stay tuned for the Dan Hicken and Rava and more next.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Ladies and gents, please put your hands together as Dan Hicken enters the studio.
This is how we do.
It's Friday.
You know it! Yes, sir! Sweet Friday! Motion, please.
Hey!
Ho! So you're just captured on tape with no emotion.
Hey.
You go against it.
Sad, dead, depressed, sleepy eyes.
Yeah. What's up, E?
Yeah!
E, you should have two words this morning.
Huh? What?
Roll Tide!
Roll Tide, baby! Shut up, man! Crimson Tide beating up on some Tobacco Road boys.
Yesterday.
North Carolina's dead to me.
Yesterday he was saying.
Yeah, he hated the pick.
Oh, I picked that. Alabama.
I did.
I was dumb. One so dumb. The big fella had a night last night. That guy. We shut Alabama down twice.
No. Alabama's terrible. Hey, North Carolina.
They're not terrible.
They lost to every good team they played, Dan, away from home. They're 24-11. They're not terrible. They are nothing special.
They play Clemson for a right to go to the Final Four.
They lost to Clemson, by the way, earlier this year.
I know.
That's what the bracket does to you.
You know what I'm going to do? Go Clemson.
Yeah.
Go Clemson. But wow. North Carolina, they're dead to me. All you Carolina Blue wearers out there, your team's a sissy program.
Hey, Graham Cam.
Well,
stop it.
Right now, if you're scoring at home in the wheel challenge,
Yeah.
Not good.
He leads away with 55. Uh-huh. Again, this is Dan projection, so Jeff will jump in with the real numbers. I got Dan at 49 and Jeff at 40.
That's correct. No, there's nothing.
And if my calculations are right as I sat there, I stayed up as well watching some hoop last night. I needed Illinois to bring that one home. Iowa State made me nervous.
That was a good one.
That was a big three-pointer for me.
Yeah.
My calculations are right.
Calculate.
You still have a chance.
It was 2 years ago, by the way. It wasn't last year. It was two years ago that happened. Okay. That we talked about off the air.
Well, you still.
Yeah, I got to.
But you got. There's basically.
Houston has to beat Tennessee and then win it all.
There's three games. There's like a. Yeah. In looking at the picks, yes. There's like a 4-point game, a 5-point game, and a 6-point game.
Yeah.
That are all that we have different. You got to get two of them.
I need Tennessee, Houston.
You need two of them to come your way. If you get two of them, if you get the 5 and the 6, that would be 11.
Yeah.
But I would get 4. So,
the 6,
you got to be within striking distance by the Natty Championship game.
I think I can still, to be honest with you, I forgot he's Bama 55. I may be done, actually. I thought he was
with
still
me.
52.
It's you and me now.
For sure I can't catch you?
No, you might be able to, but I don't know.
I get 6, because he's got Creighton, so I could get...
Yeah, Creighton is...
I could get 3 for Tennessee, mm-hmm. and he's done. Then I could get 4 for Tennessee to get to the Final Four, that's 7.
Yeah, but see, in terms of catching E, yes, but then you'd still be with... You're with me, because I have...
No, I'm talking about E first.
Right, okay.
He's way ahead of me, and then I worry about... So
if, he's 15 ahead of you.
He's 15 ahead of me, so I can make up...
3,
3
4,
with
7.
Tennessee. I can make up 4... I can make up another five with Houston winning the Final Four game because he has Creighton.
Six in the championship.
Yeah, so and then six in the championship. If Tennessee goes to the Final Four and Houston wins it all, that's the only way I'm alive. Nothing else matters because we all have UConn till the end.
Yeah.
Because y'all have UConn winning. I have Houston winning. The problem with this, there's many, many problems with this.
There's a lot of scenarios.
No, and I don't believe in any of these. Now, sitting here now, UConn's winning it all.
Yeah.
Houston certainly is not. Tennessee is not going to the Final Four. They're going to either lose to Creighton or Purdue. So, inevitably, after a long, blissful, you know, absence of the wheel, it's going to re-enter my life. I think the pee pants were the last time that bastard showed its face. That was two March Madness ago.
Oh, gosh. Anyway,
yeah, not happy. Not happy at all. And
let me tell you something. I will say this. Nobody, and I mean nobody, is better at snatching a loss from the jaws of victory than yours truly. So nothing would shock me with the way it goes. I've built a comfortable 9-point lead over you. I trail E by 6, and I'm not sitting here giving. Now, I'm glad I have UConn. However, I will say this again. One of these games is there's going to be UConn's going to have to, you know, I mean, they have won now, what, 9 games by double digits?
I don't know, Dan.
In the last 2 years?
It better be Illinois.
Yeah.
Because they're going to have the winner of Alabama-Clemson waiting on it. And I'm here to tell you about your Bama squad that closed their eyes, threw it up in the air, and won the game last night. UConn will beat them by 20.
I thought.
I'm not big on Alabama. I'm shocked, dude.
I'm not good at. Did you stayed up and watched Alabama North Carolina?
I got to just in the early second half. I fell
asleep. Okay. They made a move. The Nelson kid, the big tall white kid. They started feeding him the ball, and Carolina had a guy who's like a foot smaller covering him.
Yeah.
And I don't know why they didn't. Carolina should have made an adjustment because he went on a 7-0 run personally. They couldn't stop him. And that let them get back in the lead, and then Carolina came back. And the kid who didn't play good for Carolina was the R.J. Davis. Is that his name?
Yeah.
He's their baller.
He had a terrible
game. He did not have a good game. He terrible. Did not have a good
game. And
the
other guy, I told you I didn't believe in that Caleb Love, did I not?
Yeah.
We had this conversation yesterday even. Arizona doesn't surprise me at all.
Clemson is the shocker so far.
It opened up so much for me, Hick. I mean, North Carolina or Alabama, that's a layup, man. Again, yeah. I'm not saying Alabama's terrible. Alabama's Florida.
Yeah.
This would be like if Florida beat North Carolina. That's a fact. Alabama, Florida, the same team. And so I'm shocked that Carolina let that opportunity get away.
Yeah.
I mean, they got Clemson waiting on them.
I know.
I'm shocked. And now we got a football matchup in the Elite Eight.
I know. Alabama, Clemson. How about that? Nothing screams opening day like bad umpiring. And I got some of that last night. I was watching the umpire gave the Cubs a game, and then the Cubs blew it.
Yeah, because of the foul ball. I ended up watching a lot of baseball yesterday,
I did too.
Despite my protests.
You cannot – I saw the Yankees-Astros. I saw the Rangers last night. I saw a bunch, too. You cannot make that – and it has to be reviewable.
Yeah,
here we are, the first day of the season, I'm already annoyed at the umpires. And the guy behind the plate stunk. And it wasn't just that. He's missing calls.
I didn't watch a lot of that game, but I did was watching the end and saw that happen.
I saw a decent amount. He's changing the outcome of at-bats by missing strikes. He was terrible. Mm. But then in the ninth inning, with a runner on second, the guy, and again, the kid behind the plate, is it Heim? Is that how you say his name?
Yeah.
For the Rangers?
Heim.
All right, so.
The Rangers are good, man.
They are good. He swings and it's a foul ball, and the ball rolls away from him.
Now, in fairness, it just barely clicked off the bat. In slow motion, you can see it. I doubt you could. But to your point, it was obviously a foul tip.
Here's the problem. Why isn't it reviewable?
I don't have any idea. I wanted the same
thing.
It makes
no sense.
I'm watching the game, saying, well, just review it. And then the pitch comes. What?
So, listen, by blowing the call, you're automatically giving the kid third base because the kid's off and running, right? Because the ball gets away from the catcher because he fouls it off, changes the trajectory, kind of goes off his foot about 8 feet behind him. Now, the catcher makes the mistake because the ump looks at him like he's got a turd in his mouth. And so the kid wheels around third and keeps coming, goes all the way home and slides in safe with a steal of home because the catcher, once the ump looked at him funny, should have went and got the ball, and he didn't. That's the only mistake the catcher made. But I get it, man. Your first instinct is, man, he fouled it off.
Right.
He fouled it off.
This is obvious. Yeah.
So I would think you would want to make that reviewable. I don't know why. You can pretty much, because if you watch in sports now, the camera work is so, not the camera work, but the quality of the picture is so good, you can see the spin on the ball. And you can usually see if the spin on the ball changes, and it clearly was a foul ball. I mean, there was no question. And then, by the way, in the Yankees-Astros game, and again, this came down to a review, I'm not so much against it, but I didn't think he tagged the I thought
he got him.
Yeah, I didn't. There was no angle that could tell you, so I get
the back
it.
One, though,
but when he reached, I don't think he tagged him.
I think I saw a jersey flutter. A jersey, like the jersey change its shape. I think he got him up here.
Uh-huh.
When he got back, when he was rolling with
the
tag.
Talking about the play.
Yeah, I think he got him there.
All right.
Well, you know what I don't like about that play? You know what's annoying about that play? And we do this in sports, but.
What?
It's an average throw.
Oh, yeah.
He's got a pop gun arm. I mean, come on. Like, he drilled him out at home. Yeah. Like we're, you know, talking about Dave Parker from the right field corner.
It wasn't Clemente like against the Orioles in the World Series. That's kind of how they headlined it.
Settle down.
Yeah.
Did you see what they did out in Oakland yesterday, by the way?
They had nobody there. I saw the stands.
They showed up. They announced 13,000. That must be the seats, but they all watched the game from the parking lot.
Oh, that's great.
So they come out, they set up in the parking lot, they just tailgate and watch from the parking lot. This will be the first time since 2006 I've missed opening day, said Jorge Leon, the president of the Oakland 68s, an influential fan group. Opening day used to be a holiday for us. We'd take the day off, celebrate from 11 a.m. to the first pitch. This is hard. Meanwhile, the fans just partied on the cracked asphalt of the Coliseum parking lot in the shadows of the crumbling bleachers.
It is crumbling.
That they used to roll into the stadium for Raiders football games. It's a sad state of affairs.
It is sad. Oakland's
a proud baseball town.
There's a movie called Major League.
Yeah.
This is Major League.
Yeah.
Owner is, like I said, I blame the city of Oakland. I hold them responsible for a lot of this. But this owner is an inept fool because he's screwing up the Vegas thing, too. I don't even know where they're going. I don't even know if they're still going to Vegas.
I think they're still going to Vegas. There's some posturing going on. But
yeah. It's the whole thing, though. That would be my biggest issue. Well, my biggest issue is my team leaving. But if it was the this owner is never going to win.
You know who the most nervous fan base in all of sports should be, and they may not even know it's them. But let me tell you, the most nervous fan base in sports when it comes to your team, whoever, the next NBA team that's having difficulties or issues with their town or their agreement or their stadium, Vegas will snatch them up in half a heartbeat.
Yeah, yeah.
Vegas has the NFL, the NHL, now MLB, I promise you.
Yeah.
Don't let Sacramento not build an arena.
Yeah.
Don't let Phoenix decide that, they'll never leave because Vegas is going to have NBA in the next 10 years. Whatever failing team decides to move, someone will, I would think.
That's fair. Best story in Major League Baseball to me is Jay Jackson. He was drafted in 08 by the Cubs. He's been on 10 different MLB rosters. He's 36. He's in his 17th season. First time he's been on an opening day roster. So shout out to Jay Jackson of the Minnesota Twins. I think that's my favorite story from opening day.
There was a guy for the Reds. It's basically the same story. This dude Martino, who had never been on. He's been around for 10,
12
years. He had two home runs. He's never been on an opening day. Never played in an opening day. So the Diamondbacks and Rangers, last year's World Series teams, impressive. Dan talked about the Rangers winning in a tight one. Diamondbacks scored 14 runs in the third inning of their game. No one's ever scored more runs in an inning in opening day history. And the real story of Major League Baseball, obviously the Braves and Mets opening today.
It all matters
Not
now.
Against each other. But
our Dreamfinders Home poll question of the day. Dreamfinders Homes, the official home builder of the PGA Tour, the Gators, and the Jags. Get off the sideline into the game. Quality build homes you can call your own. Step up your game. Visit dreamfindershomes.com to find your home. They're in 20 locations in Northeast Florida to serve you. Trevor Lawrence going into year 4. Expectations for him. I give you 4 different choices for Trevor Lawrence. We haven't had a Trevor Lawrence question in a while. 30 touchdowns, AFC playoffs. 4,000 yards passing, 9-8 again. Double-digit turnovers, or 2 words, Super Bowl. Trevor Lawrence, expectations year 4.
Okay, give him
30 touchdowns, AFC playoffs.
Okay.
4,000 yards, 9-8 again. Double-digit turnovers or two words, Super Bowl.
I think he'll throw 30 touchdowns and they'll make the playoffs. Now, I think some of those other things could also happen. It could also be double-digit turnovers. I mean, he may be that guy, which is okay if you're getting the production part. That's what he didn't have last
year. I don't mind, like, if you throw 30 touchdowns, I don't mind 10 picks.
Yeah.
I mind 7-8 fumbles.
Of course.
Can't have those.
For sure.
30 touchdowns, AFC playoffs, 69.8%. 11.8%, two-word Super Bowl. Double-digit turnovers, 10%. 8.4%, 4,000 yards, 9-8 again. 450 votes a couple hours ago at Dan Hicken on social media. For a limited time on select move-in ready homes, Dreamfinders Homes offering an amazing 3.99% interest rate in year one of your mortgage. Go to dreamfindershomes.com for more details.
I have a really good pop quiz because it's an interesting topic in and of itself. It's an interesting list. It's an interesting subject to me. It's a hypothetical one, but it's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And you brought up the quarterbacks. Quarterbacks are in the news. We had two more workout yesterday. We got the quarterback whisperer.
Have you seen the picture of Jaden Daniels with the elbow?
No.
You haven't?
No.
E, have you?
No.
Oh, you guys got to look at this. Let me get it.
Is there something wrong with the elbow?
I don't.
Is it his right elbow? His throwing elbow?
Yeah. Come take a little peek-see at this and tell me how this works. I mean, tell me what we got cooking on this thing.
Oh, my God. What is that?
Tell me how that in your mind is okay.
Is that real?
It's real.
That looks like
it's like he has two different arms, and the second part of the arm is fit into the other part of the arm.
That's got to be something going on there.
Is it like some sort of picture angle?
First of all, it looks like his elbow is very aroused. That's what it looks like.
Oh, dear. I didn't see that. I'm not sure. Oof.
I'm just saying.
Friday, man.
It is what it is. Can't unsee it.
Dan
will look at it the same.
Dr. Jesse Morris with the Osteopathic Center chimed in on social media.
That's got to be just like a weird camera angle or something.
It's awful hard to explain.
I'm not drafting that guy for an NFL team. Look at that freakish looking thing.
This guy said appears to be dealing with olecranon bursitis of his right throwing elbow.
Already?
An inflammation of the bursa, which is a sac that is usually empty and is there to protect the bone underneath. We have them in several joints, including the elbow and the knee. They're very common and more annoying than concerning as long as they're not infected.
Mm. Huh? Very ugly.
Very ugly. Very weird looking.
I got a player, mentioned quarterback talk, though. I got a player A, player B for you when we come back.
I love player A, player B.
I'm curious about your overall philosophy on the, you know, the position and the guys that play it itself, at least in one particular instance. That's a tease, man. It's a very in-depth layers.
Is it?
Layers to that tease, Dan Hicken, on a GFL Friday. We're back with a 10-minute drill next.
Now, Downtime with Dan, brought to you by Ameris Bank. Voted a top place to work in Jacksonville. Whether you need help with business, personal, or mortgage banking, we're with you. Ameris Bank is an equal housing lender. Member FDIC.
Man, Thursday was a good sports day. Lots of college basketball teams are headed into the Elite Eight with a shot to go to the Final Four this weekend. Opening day in baseball, sort of, as we got things going. But very quietly out west last night. Oh, the New York Hockey Rangers. Oh, the Rangers went to Colorado, one of the better teams out there in the West. And we went toe-to-toe with those Avalanche and went on a shootout and are able to pick up two more points. But right behind is 102 points, but the Dallas Stars have 101. We'll gladly give them the cup, the President's Cup, that is. But right behind the Rangers in that same division, Carolina keeping pace with 99. It's going down to the wire.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
You love free, and at Ameris Bank, so do we. That's why we're proud to offer worry-free, hassle-free Ameris Bank free checking. Manage your money your way with convenient access to digital, mobile, and telephone banking, all with no monthly service fee or minimum balance requirements. At Ameris Bank, we're with you. For more information or to open an account, visit our local bankers in person or online at amerisbank.com/free checking. Other fees such as overdraft fees may apply. Ameris Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, Hicken here for my friends at Lockhart Construction. They're a longtime Jacksonville business. Shane Lockhart's dad started the company. Shane doing his dad still with him. Taking care of people who live here, people like me. We've used Lockhart Construction not once, not twice, but three different times. And my son Drew's got a big project coming up for them in his house that he's moving into. So if you have a construction need, a construction thought, a construction idea, give the Lockhart family a call. I mean this when I say no job is too big and no job is too small. Their family will give your family a better living experience. You unlock better living with Lockhart Construction. You have a thought, a remodel idea, give Shane a call. He'll call you back. 994-3865. Shane Lockhart, Lockhart Construction, 994-3865.
At Honda, we appreciate all the comparisons to other vehicles. And no matter how many times they compare their vehicles to a Honda, only a Honda is a Honda. Remember, value, quality, safety. There is no substitute. Visit your local Honda dealer now and experience the difference.
Get ready for an unforgettable musical journey with the incredible Claire Vandiver at Players Grill Mandarin. Influenced by indie rock to modern pop, Claire's unique sound is a breath of fresh air. Come listen to Claire Vandiver Friday, March 29th at 8 p.m. Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit republicservices.com.
Equal opportunity employer.
You've heard fish stories.
Yeah.
And Captain Kevin has a million of them.
We love to tell stories, hear your stories.
On the Ring Power Fishing Forecast Show.
Big fish.
Brought to you by Awaken 180 Weight Loss.
Thursday nights at 6.
On 1010 XL AM.
This is Keith Catlin for Catlin Truck Accessories, and we are so blessed to be in business for over 100 years. Over 100 years of the best product and customer service means you can count on Catlin. From rolling lock bed covers to Lear toppers, Cam Locker Toolbox. Catlin Truck Accessories has you covered when it comes to your truck or van. We do those too. Got a fleet of vehicles? We can outfit them all.
Who can you count on? Count on Catlin.
One name, one location, 100 years. You can count on Catlin.
Do you have clicking, popping, swelling, or pain in your knee or shoulder? This can be due to arthritic changes in your joints. Over time, you have wear and tear of your cartilage. I am Dr. George Bari, and here at Bari Orthopedics, we have numerous ways to treat your arthritis, such as regenerative medicine, including PRP, and joint replacements with CT guidance for accuracy down to the millimeter. If you are experiencing any of these symptoms, call us for an appointment today, or log on to BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I Orthopedics.com.
Mark Watson here to tell you a little bit about HardballCreative.com. It's your online promo haven with thousands of ideas on how to promote your company. We're open 24/7, 365.
Hardball Creative. Hardball does it all.
We don't have too many cold nights on the First Coast, but when the temperature drops, you want to hit the heat button and warm up. That's where Florida Home comes in. They're the AC experts in Jacksonville, and the importance of keeping your heating system in good working order is really important. If it stops working when it gets cooler, Florida Home will leap into action and provide you with the best solution. Heater and heat pump repair service and new system installation. They do it all. Just call Florida Home AC at 777-4300, the official heating and AC partner of the Jaguars.
Yo, it's your boy E.T., and if you're still in the market for a sports book to call home, bet that nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is your one stop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with real-life Vegas experience right from that cellular device of yours. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the comfort of the crib. Sign up now and take advantage of the generous welcome bonus on your first deposit, all the way up to $1,000. Put in 200, get three. Ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun don't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you dictate where to put that cash at. And the best part about MyBookie, you can bet anything, anytime, anywhere with MyBookie. Come on, somebody.
Catch Gators baseball all season long on 1010XL. Brought to you by Farrah & Farrah, the official personal injury law firm of the Jaguars. And Renewal by Anderson, the official window and door replacement partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. 1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Now, the 10-minute drill.
This is a big one.
On 1010XL.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Hit it.
All right, we're going to knock out some sports concepts and sports rationalizations. We call it the 10-minute drill. The end of the drill, at the end of the drill, we like to hand out a prize pack. On this Good Friday, what are we handing out? You say it. I'm not.
Lamb of God live at Daly's Place July 23rd. I got tickets, but also the winner will be entered for a chance to be selected to play in the highly coveted 1010XL Guggen Golf Tournament. Winner will be selected April 10th. Slayer!
Did you see what Brian Kelly, slip of the tongue, did?
No.
The coach at LSU?
What'd he do?
They were asking him about Jaden Daniels and how he's going to do. Jaden's a great fit. Great, you know, his game translates great to the NFL. He's going to make all the great throws and do a great job for Washington.
Well, that's believable. We know where everyone's going. I feel like I can't. I feel like Caleb Williams, Dan, is way overrated. I'm not saying that he's not going to be good. But this, only because when I look at these little segmented, you know, grades in different areas and his day, I don't know. I'm not saying he's not good. He doesn't look any better than the others.
Here's why you're thinking this.
Why?
Because you're not thinking about him on the field. You're thinking about all the nuttiness that the kid brings.
Well, no, I got to be honest. I might be swayed by something that is equally as meaningless. But those pro football grades, football focused grades, in about 10 different categories, and he's number one in only one of them, surprised me.
Uh-huh.
I mean,
uh-huh.
Why is Bo Nix at number one in like six categories of, you know, great against the rush, great outside the pocket, great at this distance, and Caleb Williams, the clear-cut, generational top guy, good enough to send – Justin Fields offer, you know, a six-pack of Coke.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's what I mean. Mm. Again, I'm not predicting his demise by any stretch, and he may be, you know, terrific. But if you're looking at a quarterback, a young quarterback, which is the better barometer? Like, is a ceiling season, like if you've got a quarterback that's only been in the league between 1 and 5 years, Is his ceiling season what you should kind of use as its base for as good as he can be? Is it what you've seen overall? Does it include other things that have happened, either personal wiles or injury? Just keep that in mind. You don't have to answer it yet because I've got a player A, player B that surprised me.
Okay,
that it's going to be easy to come back at real quick.
Okay,
it started with this question yesterday. I asked Mrs. P this.
Oh, Mrs. P. Mrs. P. Contributing to the program.
Every man,
thank
every
you,
woman.
P.
Well, and I asked her a question that I think that she answered.
Did you just say every man, every woman?
Yeah.
I'm every woman.
That's ahead. My fault. Yeah. I did that.
That's you.
Yeah. I knew as soon as I said yeah, I knew it was going to be. Yeah. But I asked her a question I think a lot of Jags fans are asking, and we certainly get feedback as well, a little bit, considering what we do. Mm-hmm. But I'll ask, so I'll start the question with a Yoda. We'll put him on the spot because he doesn't have to answer to, you know, the BCBers of the world.
Okay.
Yoda, if you could have C.J. Stroud or Trevor Lawrence, who would you take? He's pain, right? It's like breaking up with a girlfriend. People don't want to say it.
No Jag fan is taking C.J. Stroud over Trevor Lawrence.
Jag fan. Let's forget that.
Yoda's a Jag fan.
Who's better then? Let's do it that way. Who do you think's better, C.J. Stroud or Trevor?
I think most NFL,
everyone's on C.J. Stroud. I didn't know this would be controversial.
I think most rational people would say
C.J. Stroud.
He had a better year, but let's see a little more.
Okay, and that's fair. But I'm just going the end of the year, these jokers around the NFL were presenting C.J. Stroud as if he were Patrick Mahomes, coming at you next year, right?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
I did a little player A, player B. Good. Okay. Yoda went with Trevor. The Yoda has spoken.
Yoda's spoken.
I go back underneath the tree stump or wherever it is Yoda goes. But this is just a player A, player B to shoot down this logic because, I mean, maybe we're dictated too much by what we get, like the fringe polarized, like, say, on the text line, right?
Mm-hmm. Trevor Lawrence couldn't carry C.J. Stroud's, you know, helmets and pads, blah, blah, blah.
Player A, Dan, 4,108 yards. Mm-hmm. That's eighth best in the NFL. Player B, 4,113 yards, ninth best.
Okay.
Player A, 23 touchdown passes. Player B, 25.
Right.
Player A, 5 interceptions. Player B, 8. Mm-hmm. Player A, 63.9% completion percentage. Player B, 66.3. Mm-hmm. Player A, 57.5 QBR. Player B, 56.1. At the very least, do those sound like the same guy?
Yes. Is that Trevor's best year?
That Player A is C.J. Stroud's excellent rookie year last year, and Player B is Trevor Lawrence way back in 2022.
Yeah.
The ceilings of these guys, don't let people walk around and tell them, Texans have taken over the division. C.J. Stroud's better in 1 year than Trevor will ever be. That's what they scream, Hick. That's what they say.
Betsy.
So don't let them tell you that. Be like Yoda. Keep your confidence in your guy. And as far as the if I had asked you, Dan, before I gave you those stats and told you how many touchdown passes and interceptions did C.J. Stroud have last year, would you have said more?
Yes.
I would have, too. So let's just settle down a little bit on the Texans now control the division.
I mean, part of it is, in fairness, that was his rookie season.
I get it.
Yeah.
And Trevor, it was his second year after the debacle with Urban Meyer the first. Right. So
it happens.
I think it's pretty measurable, and I think Trevor's year where his receivers stayed healthy and it is commiserate with the talent than Houston says. I don't think anyone thinks that that Nico Collins wouldn't be the best receiver on either team.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But anyway, so just a little bit of, keep your optimism up, I guess, as we try and rally and restart.
I love college baseball. And so early last night, I was flipping around the telly.
Okay.
And I wanted to catch a little bit of LSU and Arkansas. They were doing battle. That's a nice little weekend series starting up. Arkansas is number one. Arkansas.
That was on TV.
It was?
The game was on, SEC Network maybe. Maybe I would have had to stream it, but I saw it on I'm a big C button guy.
Yeah, you would have had to go to C button.
I'm a C button.
Anyway, so I went, let me go to SEC Network and watch this game, 485, and I turned it on and I got,
oh, it wasn't there.
My Lady Gator softball squad is
got that. That's even better for you.
Yeah, they're 29-4. They're 5-1 in the SEC.
It's amazing that you find your way to these things while the NCAA tournament's going on.
Yeah. I don't like to watch early on in the tournament. There's too much pressure. I kind of peek to see if my boys are up or down.
I wouldn't mind not doing a bracket 1 year just so I can watch the thing without all the corruption. Like, if I was just watching the game last night, I would have pulled for Alabama all night.
So, anyway, I flip over. I got my Gators, who are a young team, but they do have the reigning SEC Player of the Year, and they're playing very, I think, better than expected. They have very young pitchers. They're 29-4 and 5-1 in the SEC, and they're taking on 17th ranked Mississippi State. They're beating that A pretty good, man. I go, sixth inning here. We got 12. They got 6. We're going to the bottom of the 6. It's 12-6 Gators. So I'm in good stead here.
Okay.
And, softball games are 7 innings, so basically they got 6 outs to play with. We're in good shape, 12-6. I flip around. Next thing I know, it's Mississippi State 13, Florida 12.
Oh, no.
So we go to the 7th. They gave up 7 runs in the bottom of the 6th, Jeff Prosser, and ended up losing 13-12 to fall to 29-5 and 5-2. A nice win by Mississippi State, but my gosh, with Florida's pitching, that has been so good. That was a meltdown of epic proportions from 12-6 to 13-12. Oof. Happened to catch that before I flipped around and went and found some other things. I didn't realize the Cubs starting pitcher got hurt last night, too. So he's got a hammy. He's done for a little while.
He went sprawling off the field. It was not very athletic.
Yeah. These are sports concepts and rationalizations, and that's what I'm going with. All that said, I also will tell you that tonight, Brandon Neely will go against Mississippi State in baseball as Sully shakes up the rotation a little bit. He's taking one of his better pitchers, his closer, because you can't close when you fall behind early. And so Neely will start, and the kid who had been starting there, whose ERA is like 8, will go into the bullpen. He'll still go with Liam Peterson and Jack Caglione on the weekend, but he's going to go with Brandon Neely tonight after giving Cade Fisher plenty of opportunity. So a little bit of a change. They – keep falling behind too much so in the beginning of games. And so, as Sully said after the FSU game the other day, that nonsense has got to stop. Got to stop.
Oh, for sure.
We got a lot of traction yesterday on talking about, on social media and on this very program, we got a lot of traction about the Jags trading up. And I get the feeling that a lot of fans would like to see the Jags try to go get a bona fide number one receiver.
Where's that coming from?
What do you mean, where it's coming?
Like, what's the genesis? Is it an NFL report or is it fans
No. It's, you know, we talked about it here, and then I put it out
on social media and that type of stuff. I think that the Jags think it's a good year and they're in a perfect spot. I don't think they're going to sacrifice a bunch to move up. I think they feel like those corner receiver sweet spots can be nailed where they are. They've got to nail them.
Well, I think you might be right, but yeah. I'm telling you that.
Oh, I'm not disagreeing.
And the more I think about it, the more I would like to see us, you know, try and get. We need to try and get some superstars on this team, some stars, some power, some difference makers, to get out of this middle of the pack 9-8. Because as we get further removed from the wonderful, most enjoyable 2022 season, where we came back against Team A, Team B, Team C, Team D. How many times did we come back in 2022 from
5, I believe.
17 points down or more.
Yeah, maybe not 5 for 17, but comebacks, there were certainly a bunch of them.
Yeah, I mean, we were.
The Raiders, it was 17-0, I believe. Dallas, they were down big. The Ravens, they were down. We were down a lot. I don't know if it was quite that deep into double digits many times, but certainly a bunch.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, like Tennessee up there, we were down, I think, 14-0.
Yeah.
But we still came back and won.
Right.
Chargers.
Cowboys.
Ravens. Raiders. Raiders, you forget, was 17-0.
Shoot, there was a couple minutes left, 5-6 minutes left of the Titans game, and we were about to lose
home. Yeah, no offense.
So we were down. We were always down. And we had, again, what I've always said, and it was great. I mean, the fans came out. The place was packed. We had those night games. It's one that you'll remember forever. That season was such a joy. But in the end, we were 9-8, like we were last year, 9-8. And I feel like the reason we're 9-8 is because we don't have enough great players. And I think we need a handful of great players. And so, to that end, I would like us to acquire a great player. I would take, get me one great player in this draft, and I'd be happy. One. Just give me one if he's great. And that's why I am sort of a proponent of trying to move up in the draft. So, but that's neither here nor there. What is here nor there is Trevor's got to play better. And if Trevor becomes that great player, then all of a sudden we're in really good shape. And so I don't think I think he's had great moments. I think he's our franchise guy, but I don't think he's become a great player yet. I think we need him to become a great player. All right, 641-1010 is the number to call. You tell them what they're going to win on this Good Friday.
I have the best pop quiz that we'll have all year because of the discussion it's going to lead to.
This is joyous.
Yeah, it's not about a stat or anything else. It's the topic overall was fascinating to me. And
wonderful.
We'll package and present it in the form of a football fix.
We've had somewhat mediocre.
I mean of a pop quiz.
Oh, dear. We've had somewhat of a mediocre week. If we could bounce back with the best pop quiz that you'll ever have, that would be a big lifter-upper for this program.
Okay.
This program needs one of those right now.
It wouldn't hurt.
Yeah.
You know what the sound of that is?
I hope not. I'm not going to comment.
It's Good Friday. The greatest comeback story in the history of mankind took place this weekend. It's Easter on Sunday. Just give them away. Kill the music and give them away.
Lamb of God tickets, holla at your boy.
The Drill, from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
Satisfy your need for speed this Sunday at Richmond.
Yes, sir.
Let's get this party started.
Woohoo!
Brought to you by the Plumbers and Pipefitters Local Union 234.
Wow, look at that.
From Jacksonville's NASCAR station, 1010XL.
Hey, certainly facing interesting economic times. Me, it's comforting knowing my money's in good hands with ITP Partners. Those are Jacksonville guys. Taking care of my Jacksonville money, gang. I'm not an expert when it comes to investing. You know, throw me a 401k, throw me a SEP IRA. Tell me which. So I find people that I trust. And I trust them because as I move closer to retirement, my money grows each and every month. And that's because of the ITP partners. That's Jeff Hartman. That's Chris Bryan. That's Reagan Wright. That's Danny Abel. That's Reed Wingate. And not just me. The late, great Junie Bug, Drew, my friends, my family. of all using ITP partners. And by the way, they listen to each of us individually and they give us strategies where our goals become their priority. So it's a great time to start. It's simple. You can talk to them whenever you want. Get in the game. ITP partners are there to help. Chris at ITPpartners.com. Chris at ITPpartners.com or call 312-9751. 312-9751. ITP partners. My financial partners for life.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Hey sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion for QC Kinetics. This is the time of year to enjoy life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you love to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now. Set up a free consultation. Call them at 904-274-5522. They've got two great locations, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra Beach. Go see them. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking lasting joint pain relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. It's a fact, QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your own body's ability to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available for you. So you can walk and run and climb stairs and play golf and move again pain-free. 904-274-5522. That's QC Kinetics. Call them today.
Pickin here. You know at Zero Res, they love rugs. Fine oil rugs need to be cleaned with the right equipment and careful training. My guy at Zero Res, Gerard, is a certified master rug cleaner and has been cleaning rugs for more than 5 years. Don't trust your fine rugs to anyone. Call Zero Res right now. They are offering a BOGO on rug cleaning. Have Zero Res clean one rug, get a second rug for free. What a great time to get your rugs cleaned. Zero Res, man. Spell it forward, spell it backwards. Zero Res. It's the right way to clean.
Zero Res.
This month, Best Bet transforms into your ultimate pot of gold, dishing out over $600,000 in poker prize money across our Jacksonville, Orange Park, and St. Augustine card rooms. Feeling lucky? Try your hand in an array of exciting card games from three-card poker, Texas Hold'em, Omaha, and many, many more. Best Bet, perfect for poker aficionados and casual players looking for a fun time with friends. Players must be 18 or older. For more information, visit bestbetjacks.com. That's bestbetjacks.com.
They'll wear the helmets.
They should be fun to watch.
It's up to you if you want to wear the heels.
Helmets and Heels.
With Lauren, Taylor, and Mia.
Switched on by First Coast Lighting and Fans.
And presented by Underwood Jewelers.
Tuesday nights at 6 on 1010XL.
Hey, this is Stevie Beechurst of Beechurst Plumbing. Growing up in Jacksonville, I was always proud when my dad would point at a building and say, "I did the plumbing for that." That's the same kind of pride we instill in every plumber here at Beechurst Plumbing. And that's the kind of pride you can expect when you hire Beechurst Plumbing for your home or business. Right now, we're doing New Year's specials to get your project going. To find out how we can help you, visit BeechurstPlumbing.com. B-E-T-R-O-S Plumbing.com. Beechurst Plumbing, here to help.
Race into Gate for big offers. By big, we mean great deals on Red Bull and a chance to win tickets to the big race coming to Miami May 3rd through 5th. Buy 2 8.4-ounce cans of Red Bull, get one free. And if you're a MyGate Rewards member, you are automatically entered for a chance to win race tickets. Not a member? Download the Gate app and sign up today. See store for details. Go from good to Gate.
Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, opens today at 121 Financial Ballpark. Come early for the opening day street carnival and don't miss post-game fireworks. Tomorrow, the first 2,000 fans get a free T-shirt plus more fireworks. Then join us for Baptist Health Sunday Family Fun Day with a pre-game egg hunt. Tickets start at just $5, jackshrimp.com. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, affordable family fun.
Yo, this is Tony from Tony D's. Are you looking for a great slice of pizza? Well, we have about 12 varieties. Most places won't have slices of pizza after lunch. At Tony D's, you can get a slice all day. It's always fresh at Tony D's Pizza, Bay Meadows and 295.
There are three certainties in life: death, taxes, and if you stay in your home long enough, a new roof. Hickin' here for our friends at Lockhart Roofing. Nobody better in Jacksonville. How do I know? They are a local certified Master Elite contractor, and that means they have a GAF Master Elite warranty. That's the best in the roofing industry. In this day and age, don't settle for cheaper discount roofers. Lockhart Roofing has been here for decades. They aren't going anywhere. Call my friends at Lockhart Roofing, 994-3851. That's 994-3851. Lockhart Roofing, Jacksonville's best for Jacksonville people.
Men, suffering from ED or PE? You'll see instant results on your first visit at Prime Men's Medical Center. For a limited time, your initial consultation and first treatment are totally free. You'll even get a gift that enhances performance in the bedroom. Call 904-664-8217.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Told, I thought North Carolina favored 4.5 over Alabama was stealing, Dan Hicken. I thought it was stealing. I'm shocked at Bama, who, again, the reason I thought that is because Bama, every time this year they played a good team on the road, away from home, they've just gotten, not beaten, they've gotten hammered. I'm just shocked that North Carolina choked as bad as they did. All you Tar Heel fans out there, nice job, chokers.
Ooh. Roll Tide!
This guy yesterday, all he did was pee and moan about,
I was so mad.
Why did I pick Bama? And so now he's going to be all like, look at me. I
roll Tide, roll! Yeah. Woo! Alabaster! Woo!
Alabaster. Get you some houndstooth.
They lost
all right,
to...
We are in the era of...
They lost to Arizona, Creighton, Purdue. Boy, they played a great schedule this year.
They lost to Clemson at home.
Clemson.
But I'm talking about like away from home, at Florida, just boondoggled. Was it at Tennessee? I saw them lose by 20. I mean, that like by at Auburn by 30.
Yeah.
I mean, not just getting beat, like just getting double-digit hammered by good teams. I'm including the SEC tournament, by the way, where Florida whacked them again.
Bruce Pearl made a big mistake.
Which was?
Night. So he's in the studio.
I heard him. I didn't watch a ton.
And, you know, they're I think he's in the studio with the Alabama game. I don't know which studio.
Yeah, he was.
Was he? The Alabama game was on his studio show.
I
don't remember.
I don't know.
But he was talking. They were talking about, you know, and they joke around about how, you know, Bruce Pearl's Auburn. And he says, I'm not going to say Roll Tide. Well, you just did, because now everybody's just going to edit Roll Tide.
Yeah, that's true.
So you've made a very big mistake.
What a fantastic basketball situation has bloomed in the state of Alabama with Bruce Pearl at Auburn and Nate Oates at Bama. I mean, it's pretty year-in-year-out consistency of being a team capable of making a run. Hasn't Pearl already taken Auburn to the Final Four? Didn't they do that just a few years ago?
Yeah, Virginia. Yeah. Virginia year, right?
Yeah, so
it was an unbelievable game, if I remember.
And by the way, Alabama-Clemson, Elite Eight, one's going to make history. Two more programs, two big programs, never made a Final Four.
Oh, okay.
So, it's never paid.
I'm ready.
Any more in college football.
I'm ready.
Than to be valuable.
Okay.
We're in the age of realignment. You know, where you can land, what you can bring to certain, you know, leagues and how it can impact your program. Just how valuable are you in the eyes of the college football or sports world? This is an interesting column that I came across yesterday. Every FBS school ranked by how attractive they'd be in conference realignment.
Okay.
In other words, if every FBS school was placed in a draft, who gets taken first? Who gets taken last?
Is this for football or?
It's just FBS. That's correct. It's football only.
Okay.
The theory goes.
What makes you attractive?
Well, I'm about to get into some of the parameters. Mm-hmm. There's a dude, Tony Altimore. He's a strategy consultant. He attempted to rank every FBS program along roughly 50 factors that a television executive and or a university president would find important. Among the factors broken down into groups described includes it balances. It takes all of these factors, puts a point value on them. Then weights them based on the input from experts, creates a broad-based look at overall attractiveness. In short, he found long-term football success and television viewership are highly correlated, no surprise. basically, if you set aside how he comes up with statistics, if every FBS program were put into a pot for ESPN and Fox to draft, who gets taken first, who gets taken last? You follow?
Yeah.
Pop quiz music, please.
Oh, boy.
Tell me the top 10 most desirable football programs in the FBS.
All right, I can do – I mean
– and then we can get in – then it's a fun conversation off of this. It doesn't stop and start with the – we'll do the quiz now. We'll come back later this morning after Denny. All right, go ahead. Sorry.
Going with consistent powerhouses. Yeah, so I'm going to go with, like, Ohio State.
Number one, Ohio State, 356 points.
I'm going to go with Alabama.
Alabama number three, 301 points.
Roll Tide.
I'm going to go with Texas.
Texas number five, 282. This is that old list that we always talked about, the best college football job, right? Rank the college football jobs. That's almost what this is.
I'll go with Notre Dame.
Notre Dame's number six, 279.
That's always a debatable one. Why they, you know.
Which thing about SC, Dan?
Let's go Michigan first.
Michigan's number two, 337. USC is number four, 296. You've gotten one Ohio State, two Michigan, three Alabama, four USC, five Texas, and six Notre Dame. You've got the top six in order. You're missing 7 through 10.
Is Georgia ready to jump in there?
Ooh, yeah, they might.
Or LSU.
Oof.
Let's go Georgia.
Georgia number seven.
Okay.
269.9. I would assume that the fluctuating TV markets, Atlanta getting bigger and bigger and New Orleans getting smaller and smaller, probably is why Georgia is. I'm going to do a hint here. LSU out, not in the top 10. They're number 12. Okay. Georgia is 7. 3 more. 8, 9, and 10. I would say.
What do you think of.
I would say two of the three are a surprise. One is a huge surprise. The other, not quite as big a surprise.
What do you think of Penn State?
Yeah.
Penn State's number eight. Not going to let you talk yourself out of it. 263.1. Okay. We've gone 1 through 8.
So the next two are the surprises.
Two left. One of them you were not going to get. One of them you're not going to get. I'm positive.
Read the ones that I've gotten again.
All right. In order. Again, these are the attractiveness. If there were like a draft for realignment. Ohio State, Michigan, Alabama, USC. Texas, Notre Dame, Georgia, Penn State. In order, that's 1 to 8. You have two left, number 9 and number 10. What are you thinking? What programs are up there pecking at
I'm
your brain?
I'm thinking like Oklahoma's crossed my mind. I don't know, maybe you brought it up because Florida would be good. USC's still floating around.
USC, no, we already have.
We already got four. That's four.
Okay, we got them.
Yeah.
Let me just throw some names just in case you hadn't thought of them in no particular order. I'm literally bouncing around between the ones that are there, but among the programs you haven't said, well, you said Florida, Oklahoma, Tennessee, Clemson, FSU, Texas A&M, Michigan State.
Texas A&M is kind of a surpriser, but we put Texas in there. Let's go Oklahoma.
And the game ends. Oklahoma's number 11. And I disagree that there's a school just ahead of them. I'm really surprised at who is number 10. Yeah, you were right on one thing. Of course I did it because Florida, number 9, baby. Go Gators. Hadn't won a damn thing in 10 years. Still the ninth most attractive football program. By the way, FSU, enjoy that time down there at number 19, boys. Keep playing hard. One day they'll want you as much.
Dang.
Number 10, though, was the shocker to me, and I guess it's just strictly the market, but UCLA ain't never won nothing in football.
Deshaun Foster.
LA. But I'm thinking they're also thinking Big Ten now. You have that, although it's for realignment. Oklahoma was 11.
Where's A&M?
13. Yeah. Oklahoma 11, LSU 12, Texas A&M 13, Washington 14, Stanford 15.
All right, we got the quarterback whisperer, Denny Thompson, in the house. We'll hang out with him for a little bit here. Coming up on The Drill.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
I'm Austin Dillon, driver of the number 3 Bass Pro Shop Chevrolet.
But it's Austin Dillon who wins at Daytona!
And you're listening to 1010XL, Jax Sports Radio.
Comes to insurance, folks like me think like this. Look, gang, We pay a lot of money monthly, so if something happens and we need you, you need to be there. That's what the Kaprowskis, Craig and Chris, do. They've teamed up to take care of all of our insurance needs. And when I say take care, I mean it, right? If something happens, you call the Kaprowskis. They answer. They immediately jump on what you need to happen. If they don't answer, they call you right back. It's called customer service. And it's very important to the Kaprowskis. They don't take it lightly. So homeowners, auto, flood, boat insurance, small business, Kaprowskis are there for you at your time of need. How do I know this? I know it firsthand because they've helped me. They've helped my family on numerous occasions. Get an insurance checkup today. Craig.Kaprowski at Goosehead.com. Craig.Kaprowski, K-O-P-R-O-S-K-I at Goosehead.com or call 478-8422, 478-8422. Craig Kaprowski are part of the Goosehead Insurance family and part of our family as well.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Did you hear what's happening? Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet are spring cleaning. New inventory on the ground means we need to make more room. Take advantage of huge savings on thousands of vehicles priced to sell. New and pre-owned prices have been reduced and all sales associates have been instructed to give maximum value on all trades. But you better hurry, the best deals go first. Head to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine
or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville to take advantage of our spring cleaning sale.
We're here to wow you.
Yo, it's your boy E.T. And if you're still in the market for a sportsbook to call home, bet that nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is your one stop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with real-life Vegas experience right from that cellular device of yours. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the comfort of the crib. Sign up now and take advantage of the generous welcome bonus on your first deposit, all the way up to $1,000. Put in $200, get three. Ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun don't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you dictate where to put that cash at. And the best part about MyBookie, you can bet anything, anytime, anywhere with MyBookie. Come on, somebody.
Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute is the sports medicine leader in Northeast Florida. We're proud to be the official sports medicine provider for your hometown teams, including the Jaguars, Sharks, Axemen, and the Jumbo Shrimp. We have the most cutting-edge resources for sports medicine care, including Active Armor Casting, Alter-G Anti-Gravity Treadmills, and highly trained physicians and athletic trainers. JOI is truly where the pros go, and so should you.
Home of the Jaguars, WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach, WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Divorce, menonly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to divorcemenonly.com. Divorcemenonly.com. Offices Jacksonville.
It's back. The biggest jewelry sale of the year. Buy one, get one at Beard's Diamonds.
No other jewelry store in North Florida can match it. Buy any band and get the other one free.
The whole month of April.
Beard's Diamonds will beat any competitor's price.
At the St. John's Town Center.
Leon Searcy here, Jaguar legend and three-time national champion. Are you ready to elevate your game and dominate on the gridiron? Our elite offensive line camp is designed for young athletes who aspire to push their limits, refine their skills, and become the very best. It's called the Lineman Life. Sunday, April 14th, D1 training on Beach Boulevard. Whether you are aiming to make a starting lineup or a college scholarship, this camp is for you. Spots are limited, so secure your spot now. Go to eventbrite.com, the Lineman Life, dash offensive line camp. Enter promo code 1010 and get $25 off. Greatness awaits.
Get ready to rock your evening with the band Be Easy at Players Grill Mandarin, a high-energy, multi-genre cover band from classic hits to chart toppers. See you at Players Grill Mandarin Friday, April 5th at 8 p.m. Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
Well, I'd like to think that you know this already, and I sure hope you have experienced it if you're a pet owner. Because if you're a pet owner, there is only one place that gets you the peace of mind that you want, and it's a perfect name. It's Pet Paradise. It's the ultimate home away from home for your four-leg family member. Whether your pet prefers a splash in the pool or just making new friends, Pet Paradise's team of pet lovers now, pet-loving pros, going to ensure the most important pet in your world has a great visit, whether it's day camp or an overnight stay. Oh, by the way, inside these ultra-modern facilities, dotting the First Coast, I believe 8 or 9 locations now, it's always any and everything you need under one roof. They have professional grooming services, veterinary services with New Day Veterinary Care. At Pet Paradise, it's top shelf customer service and treatment for that member of your family, that four-legged member of your family. So go to Pet Paradise right now. Book an appointment. Find out what they're all about at petparadise.com.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, sponsored by Waken 180 Weight Loss. Following the Knowles scrimmage for spring football camp, head coach Mike Norville was asked to size up his QBs.
Brock does have a year within the system. You know, I think DJ's done really well in this overall understanding. You know, I thought Luke was a first round, Luke was outstanding.
CBS NFL studio analyst and former New York Giant QB Phil Simms appeared on Into the Night and commented on what he'd like to see from Jag QB Trevor Lawrence.
Better performance on the field, leading, and being a force in the team.
The Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp, the 2024 season, begins this evening with a 3-game series against the Gwinnett Stripers, a AAA affiliate of the Atlanta Braves. That runs through Sunday, March 31st, at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. And that's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Sam Nelson.
It's 8:07 and it's 51 degrees time and temp, brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Now, the quarterback whisperer, Denny Thompson.
Okay, bring it in.
Brought to you by Tyson Sound and Security, security and automation experts, and George Moore Chevrolet.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, yes. There he is, the quarterback whisperer, Denny Thompson. I'm going to ask you for some inside information, Denny. And this is good because you don't have to give up any real
inside information.
Right. Yeah. This is, I like
even
this.
Though you just told everybody it's inside information. So it I is. Guess, actually, I'm just asking you for some information.
No. I don't want you to name names.
Okay. There,
but I want you to tell me this, Denny Thompson. You get a quarterback. Your team gets a quarterback.
Boom, boom.
And he is small in stature.
Okay.
And he's got his pro day or the combine or something where he is going to step on the scale and get the official weight.
Right.
And we're a week out and we got problems.
Okay.
How much weight can you comfortably put on a person so when he steps on the scale, you're happy with the number in a week's time?
Okay, there's multiple people you could be talking about on this.
Exactly. This is a good question.
Is he just weighing, or is he then weighing and then has to work out?
Correct. See, he has to weigh, and then he's going to throw.
Okay.
He's not going to – I'm not running, though. I stand on my run time.
Yeah, okay.
So.
Well, Bryce Young showed us last year that you can
– yeah.
You can do some work.
But I want you to tell me what we're doing, what we're eating, what's happening, how much weight. Give me a number.
This is such a Tom and Jenna question, though, for me.
I know, but
– I'm going to go in a week.
Yeah.
I would say a solid 6 pounds.
6 pounds?
Yeah.
Okay. If you got – you start putting on 10 to 15, you'd be a little concerned?
Well, I mean, I don't know how good they're going to –
be a little sluggy?
Perform.
A little sloshy.
Yeah, it's the performance after that worries me. Yeah.
The liquid in my belly is moving around.
Blubber quotient.
I got a little jiggly. Right. Jiggly, jiggly, jiggly.
Why? I don't even know what you're referring to.
I'm not. Well, I'm referring to the magic. You know, we used to go by height, but now that we've got rid of the height thing, because we have so many 6'1 quarterbacks,
right.
6'2 quarterbacks, used to be you had to be this tall.
Right.
Right. And then the last 10 years, you know, we get little guy after little guy after little guy. Some are successful, some are not. But we sort of dispelled. You don't have to be 6'4".
Has there been a bigger change in importance of a stat in the last 15 years?
Than height?
No. Than a quarterback's 40 time.
Yeah, the mobile quarterback.
Yeah. Like it used to never be. If the quarterback's 40 time, unless you were a Mike Vick and they wondered, could you throw it on? We never cared a lick about a quarterback's 40 time.
Yeah, well, they got athletes playing.
That's what
yeah,
I'm saying. Like Michael Penix running sub 4.6 was newsworthy more than Michael Penix threw it 75 yards in the air.
Well, the one that gets picked apart for quarterbacks is the 10 split.
Okay.
Like that's okay. The
is that
number.
The escapability
that was
number?
Birdie yeah. had a great number
yeah.
from that, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's obviously correlation between the two. The faster you run 10, the faster you're going to 40. But
to answer your question, the reason I brought it up is because of the 205 mark with Jaden Daniels. He was 210 at his workout.
Yes, that's about right.
And he's tall, but he's a string bean. And the other thing I noticed about Jaden Daniels, to change the subject a little bit, because I watched him a pretty good amount. The Florida Gators won him a Heisman Trophy and some other things. But that dude takes on hits. And he's going to have to change that a little bit.
Yeah,
do
you see
NFL.
The, what, I guess somebody put it out yesterday and it went viral of all the hits he's taken?
No.
Oh,
but he
gosh.
Takes some hits, right?
Yes.
And he doesn't go down. He's got to go down. In the NFL, he will get killed if he does
planted,
it.
Planted. Yes. No doubt. I don't, like, you're either going to learn that or you're going to be out of the league.
Correct.
Year.
No, 100%.
It's just that simple for him. But I can't make up my mind because I saw a little bit of his pro day the other day. Like, just a couple videos that were put together. I can't make up my mind, though, on his frame. I can't make up my mind on what is going to happen in the next three or 4 years. Like, Bryce is slight.
He's a little dude. Jaden Daniels could fill out.
Yeah, Jaden doesn't look as slight as Bryce
to me. No, but he's still
–
I'm surprised he's so light.
Oh, yeah, no, same.
Because I know he put on weight. I know he wanted to be over the 205. He got to 210. Now, he's had a long time. He didn't weigh in at the combine.
Right.
So, I knew he was pointing for this day, so he's been working hard to get the weight on, but – you can't help but wonder, okay, if it says 210, ultimately you're probably going to be like 202 or whatever.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't either.
Some guys go – I guess my point is some guys, they get out of this amazing strength program they've had in college. They get there, they put on 15 pounds like that. Like anytime you see a kid leave for college in January, when you see him again at spring break, you're like, what is happening over there?
Here's the one I don't understand, Denny, and you can explain this to me. Like, okay, you're a top quarterback like Caleb Williams or Jaden Daniels or Drake May. This is where I would draw the line. The other stuff I don't necessarily get, but if Washington says, we're coming to see you and we want you to throw, I'm not throwing. I already threw twice. I'm not throwing anymore.
Yeah.
But they do, right? Don't they keep throwing or no? Do the big boys not throw?
Not much.
Okay.
Yeah, not
I don't
much.
Want to throw anymore.
I mean, there's so much
I mean, you've gotten all the film. You've seen me throw
especially
my pro day.
Especially this class.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, who doesn't have film? I guess JJ. JJ don't have a ton of film. But outside of him – like every, but that's the unique thing about this class is there is so much film on these guys. Like, why do you need to see them throw more?
And did anybody have a bad pro day? I mean, we've gone over this before, but I don't understand.
You can't have a bad pro day.
Well, I mean, I'm reading this one guy on social media, and I don't know. Because you got to go to some rogue site now to watch pro days.
I know.
The only way I'm watching a pro day is if I happen to flip by it and the guy's throwing. I'm like, oh, look, let's see him throw. I don't care.
Good for you.
Yeah, it's a waste of time. But I read this one guy, Jaden Daniels' pro day was horrible, and I'm like, and then I see stats. He was 23 of 25, and I mean,
there should not be stats at a pro day.
I know,
right.
I know, and I mean, Brunell was one who told me years ago, if you're throwing against air, you should never miss.
Right, never.
Yeah. Right,
if you're a pro quarterback, never. I think honestly,
well, no, never's tough. Never's tough.
Yeah,
especially
I might drop one
because there
well,
was
well, the drop one's different.
I'm no, hold on, no, let me like. Because these receivers are so charged up. We had this at a couple of our pro days. Hey, you're going to run a 12-yard. You're going to bend it at 12. And we look up, and they're at 16.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
So stuff. But your point, if you're with your guys.
Yes.
Yeah, that's not a hard.
It's I mean, I feel like I could go out and go 48 for 50.
That's what I'm saying.
Right,
I mean, 40-year-old men that just are still relatively active can.
Right, right. But there is something to the pro day, I think, of being able to see how a guy is responded to by his teammates because that's what it is. As well as just how does he run that pro day? We had Austin Reeds this week, past week, and it went really well. And everything could have gone wrong because there was a 25-mile-per-hour crosswind.
Ooh, dear.
The entire time.
We hate getting up to that.
And one of his receivers, like, tweaked a hammy right before we running the 40. So it's like that was a time, though, for Austin to go, hey, I'm going to take control of this, and he did. So I think there's more to it than just –
give me a little background on Austin Reeds pro day versus, like, you've been – you were at Anthony's, you were at Caleb's. Those are the creme de la cremes, and everybody goes.
Yeah.
Who goes to Austin Reed's pro day?
Well,
like what kind of numbers do we get there?
All 32 teams were there.
Really?
But they have a receiver who is out of this world.
Okay.
Malachi Corley.
Oh, yeah, we've heard of him.
Yeah. I mean, could be first-rounder type guy. Like, he is special. Yeah. So that flawed it
that
a little
helped,
bit.
That helps, though. That's good.
Yeah, but I mean, I would think if he wasn't there, Austin would still have 20 teams there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not necessarily head coaches and GMs.
No. It's a different group of guys than what was at
Caleb's. Danny Dan Hicken, receivers coach in Cleveland. Nice to see you.
Receiver analytics.
What's the difference in the ball in college and pro?
Oh, the Pro's so much better. It's better leather.
It's bigger. Is it the same too, size?
Bit, it's a little bit bigger. A
little bit.
Fits your hand just perfectly. If you're like, if you've got over a nine and a quarter inch hand, like it is, it spins itself.
You like to deflate it?
No. No, actually, that's the
why wouldn't they not be uniform at this stage?
I don't. We have been asking the same thing. Like, if you like the
even
stripes,
if you wanted to put the stripes, but make the stripes it the same
on that
ball.
Bad boy. Yeah.
Is there ever any sort of, you know, transition going from that ball to the next
I have
one? Has there
never,
ever been the story of anyone? Yeah,
I've never had
so.
A single person say, man, I like the college ball better.
Yeah.
It's okay. Like every one of them puts that NFL ball in their hands. Like, even the college guys that come in will throw the Ooh. NFL ball.
Yeah.
Like, they wouldn't even throw their ball.
Yeah.
I don't know. I know there was, I think FSU went down that rabbit hole a couple years ago of can we not just throw stripes on this?
Mm-hmm.
And I guess the NCAA shot
did. Speaking of FSU, somebody I was going to ask about, ear to the ground, you hear anything on Jordan Travis? I know he's on schedule to be back.
Yeah, he's here.
To full health. He's with you.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Okay, well, then give us an update on Jordan. Is there any?
He's just started throwing.
His leg will be back in May, June? Is that what they're thinking? Or no?
I don't know. For sure. I don't know for
Is he walk? Is he getting around without a limp? And
Yeah. He's I mean,
is he going to be drafted?
I don't know. We just got him this week.
Okay.
I mean, he obviously has had some physical.
Have you worked with him before, or is this a new relationship?
No, it's a new relationship. Mm-hmm. The medical side of things that we have is top notch. Like Dr. Gormley is top notch. So he does a ton of physical therapy, things like that. I know nothing about these guys other than, hey, we're throwing it this time, so I need to be there. But outside of that, I mean, Tom and Will take care of 99% of that stuff. But awesome dude. I will say that.
Well, it's just interesting. There were times last year where you would find Jordan Travis in the first round of mock drafts. Now, that may have been, you know, maybe overshooting. He's not a big dude. I don't know if he was ever a first rounder, but he certainly was going to, with the way the NFL is played today.
Yeah.
You know, he fits right into like a Jalen Hurts backup.
He's a slight guy. Slight
yeah, he's not a big dude, is he?
Yeah, yeah. I was thinking, actually, when
now,
you were
been
talking
around
about Jaden, I was thinking about him as well. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. There, I think he may weigh a little more than that. I'm not
really
sure.
What he lists at.
But he's a guy that when you look at, you're like, well, wait a second. This guy can put something on, you know, put together really well.
So 6'1", 212.
Well, what I love about Travis, I mean, it's I like guys every year I see him, they're better than the last time I saw him.
Definitely got better.
Every year he was better, and he was good, and the last 2 years was really good. So I would be intrigued for a prospect to get him, you know, give him the Purdy treatment, get him around 6 or 7.
Yeah, there's some guy. Oh, I think my personal opinion is he'll be gone before then. But I think there's some guys that just play football so well that you got to just take a chance on them.
Okay,
like maybe football everything player. Is. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like they're just so good at football.
Oh, Denny, small hands, 9 inches.
That's fine.
That's fine.
No, that's fine. If it's got an 8 in front of it, that's a concern.
Okay.
But if it's, that 9's fine. But, yeah, he is such just a good football player.
He is a good football player.
I was just curious. I haven't heard much of him. I did see an update, I don't know, a couple, 3 weeks ago. Maybe it was from the combine. He seemed on track physically to be full go by May or June. I'm just wondering.
He was at their pro day. He was at the FSU pro day.
It'll be after the – I wonder if teams are talking. I mean, I just wonder what you do if you're a team because none of those – none of those updates come until after the draft.
Well, I think also if you look at this class and you're looking for guys that could potentially become a starter for your team, there's not many of those guys in this class. And I think he is one of those guys. Yeah, it's either going to – I feel like Jordan would be a long-term player in the NFL, but if he hits, you got a superstar. If
you know,
he's able to do it in the NFL, what he can do in college, you got a superstar. So why not take him in the fourth or fifth?
Ladies and gentlemen, there is only one quarterback, and he's not a full-time quarterback, in the NFL who has a hand size with an 8 in front of it.
Only one.
Well, that's not true.
Kenny Pickett.
Who?
Kenny Pickett is certainly one.
Stand by.
Who did you have?
I'm going to guess Taysom Hill is the only other one that
Taysom
I
Hill,
think is
very good.
Not a full-time quarterback. I'm a Saints.
Oh, Kenny Pickett. Yeah, 8.5.
Yeah.
Kenny Pickett and Taysom Hill.
Yeah.
Joe Burrow, though, is just 9.
Yeah.
Jared Goff, just 9. Mm-hmm. Trevor 10. Who has the biggest hands in the NFL? What quarterback?
It's got to be Aaron Rodgers.
You're wrong.
Didn't Deshaun Watson have big hands?
Wrong and wrong.
Who is it? It's not Mahomes.
Russ.
Russ.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
How'd you know that?
He's little.
I'll guess.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
What do you do? You measure from pinky to...
Here to here.
Here to here, yeah. You just kind of press down like this, and there's
you
gotta, got a ruler.
You got to widen it out. Yeah. Denny, do you give them... You guys give them drills to get that extra quarter inch.
There are guys that do that.
They teach them how to get that extra little something-something.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's
we've
so
done
funny.
This before, and to be... So you think
Chew has some big hands.
Well,
10 and 8.
Well, I would say we've done this before, like, in contrast with, like, Joe Burrow, and, like, just average people, like, it's closer to, like... Like Dan will be 8.5.
Yeah, oh yeah.
No, that's
I'm
a little head.
I'm over 9.
Yeah, I'm like I remember doing it and being like higher than some of even the prospects. So it's
it's not just these guys are walking around with those foam hands. Like
right.
And you really can't tell the difference in a small hand. Like if you just go shake their hand. But everybody has kind of figured out, I guess history has told us that 9 with the ball that we use and the weather that they play in is about where you need to be. By the way, Anthony Richardson's brother. Who is 13-year-old
with a
His 30-year-old little brother.
He has like over a 10-inch hand arm.
Oh my god!
His little brother that's
and
older
a carton
than him.
And a carton of Pall Mall.
Does he smoke heaters? Yes or no? What is his? How old is he?
42.
13 or 14.
He lives in Indy now, right?
Yeah.
And does he? So is he in like 8th or 9th grade? Is he
actually,
middle school?
He must be 14 because he was in 9th grade last year.
So he'll be a varsity quarterback somewhere this year?
I don't know if he's going to play quarterback. He's a track guy.
You know, I got to say this about, and we've said this a million times, but I was talking to one of my students.
He's going to get drafted into the Army.
I was talking about. Man,
kid looks 36.
I want to say this about Anthony Richardson.
Tough life.
A couple things about Anthony Richardson.
Okay.
I was talking to one of my students who played against him in high school, and they beat his ass. He was on. But this is what I love about Anthony Richardson. I'll say this, man. The kid stayed at his high school. He could have gone any other high school and played on a winner. He stayed on a crap team.
East Side he went?
Right?
East Side. Yeah, because
so
GHS
one.
And Buchholz both take turns
then,
being decent. East Side, you never
Then we hear it. The stories about Anthony in Gainesville after he went to Florida and games are over and he's hanging out with the kids and goofing around, throwing footballs. That's two. Then the Gators go to Indianapolis. He's courtside with his Gators shirt. Gator fans should always embrace Anthony Richardson, man. He didn't win.
I think they do.
They were hard on him when he was there. Yeah. We can all say. But they should, as time goes, he loves Florida, man.
He does love Florida.
And so I shout out to Anthony Richardson, man. He gave us his all. You know, it didn't always look great.
Mullen should have played him.
Battled
injuries. For the
injuries
good of the program and for his future.
We could turn our hatred towards Mullen more than Anthony Richardson. That's fine. But I just think he's there's so many good qualities. I really wish he wasn't on Indy.
Well, that there's certainly one thing that you can't argue about is he is a elite individual.
He is an elite. Dude, he stops his car up in Indy because some lady's on the side of the road with a broken down car changes her tires, didn't he?
And then goes to the tire store and comes back, or to the auto parts store and comes back.
I mean, nobody does that.
Yeah. Yeah. And he does that stuff like all the time, like shows up at random people's
or houses,
birthdays.
Yes.
And he understands the risk.
Yeah.
Like Anthony's a smart guy.
Right, right.
But he's just got this like love for people about it.
He does. And I he's a good, good person, man. And that, to me, that still matters. So anyway, tip of the cap to him and you brought it up his brother. That's why I started thinking about him. I've been wanting to say that. But when you're sitting courtside in Indy, you go see your boys, your hoop team, and you're gatored up. I mean, that's
well,
you're
pay
one
attention
of us,
too,
bro.
Because the NBA All-Star game was also in Indy.
Uh-huh.
And he was not there.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It's not like this guy's
right.
If it's important to him,
yes,
he's going. So Florida's important enough that he's like, you know what, I'm going there.
Or like even when he was here training in Jacksonville, he would go to random
high school games. Yep.
And all the dudes would go up and get pictures with him. My son would go. I mean – You know, and you, I mean, so anyway, good person.
Yeah, good dude.
Rooting for him, you know, 15 games a year.
So good dude.
My hope is that he can, I just want him to stay healthy.
Yeah.
Let's see what he can do. Just stay healthy, Anthony, and let's see what you can do on the football field given a full season.
I can confirm that he would like to stay healthy as well.
You can confirm that?
Yes, I can
He's
confirm
not looking
that.
To get hurt.
Yes.
In other news, I don't want to get sick either. It has nothing to do with the NFL.
A side note here for Jeff and Denny, you can play as well, but you brought this up yesterday, Jeff. It was probably even off air, but we were talking about PNC Park and the baseball stadium in Pittsburgh. And it's been around for a little bit now, right?
Yeah, probably 20 years.
Yeah.
Wow. Has it been that long?
23 seasons.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
I just tell him I want to go
there. You think of it
there.
As a new park, but it's 23
it's like
years
San Francisco's.
Old.
My second plan, Dan, was involving like a weekend or like a summer baseball trip. Like I said, I think I'm just down. I'll just go with the wife and do one. So you're looking for something more than just the game, but we're thinking about maybe doing like the Red Sox going to Cape Cod. I've never been to Cape up that area.
Oh, that's beautiful.
The problem is when the Red Sox series is. We'll have to talk about that later. In other words, to make it work.
I've never been
to Fenway or Wrigley.
I've been to both. Yeah, they're neither is anything special other than the history.
Yeah, and I don't expect anything special.
I think they're awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love them.
Yeah. Absolutely love them.
If you like black and white TV versus HD,
have you ever seen, the drone at Wrigley Field?
I don't know. I'm sure I have.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, they fly it through the...
Oh, yeah.
So cool.
Yeah.
Wrigley is...
They're just old wooden ballparks. It's like going to old Wolfson Park.
Don't listen to him.
I've been there. It's more than him.
It's neighborhood baseball, Denny. It's like when...
It's like 1940s.
It takes you back in time. It's the timelessness of the game.
Right.
We went to Wrigley one year. We walked from Wrigley back to downtown Chicago. It was such a beautiful day. And it's
all of which has nothing to do with the stadium.
Doesn't matter. The stadium reeks like... You go to Pesky Pole. You swing. You sing.
No, I get
Sweet
all that.
Caroline.
No, I want to do that one time because it's only a matter of time, right? Before they have to do something with these stadiums.
I don't know. They've revamped both. I think they're going to stay
money
with
into
it.
Them.
Yeah, but if Yankee Stadium can or will, then they are going to. I'll tell you another one. Needs to be is Dodger Stadium. That thing's old and
no doubt.
They still like that one. But take his point. It's the charm, but it really is. It'll be like going to Old Wolfson Park if you ever went there. There aren't very many modern stadiums that still give you a obstructed view, if you feel me. Getting inside. It's not built for today's congestion inside and all that. But it's,
underrated stadium is KC.
Yeah. Not bad at all.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not.
They have a new one, too. I haven't been to the new one.
Oh, did they? Or did they just renovated it?
Well, they redid it.
Yeah, they redid it.
Yeah. They used to have the fountain out in the.
No.
But it's, like, very comfortable.
Yeah.
I always enjoy going to Tampa games because I'd have
plenty of room.
Whole row.
Here's the problem with Tampa, and you're right. Tampa is a double-edged sword. Go to Tampa when it's not crowded and it's awesome. But if you go down for a Braves series, the place fills up and it's too congested. It was a total different experience on game day in Tampa with a full stadium versus an empty one.
Yeah, I mean it's
and
very,
most of the time
very cozy usually.
Yeah,
yeah.
But it was packed when we were there too much.
Yeah, no. That
for the Braves series, so the Braves won both games. By the way,
what's on the schedule for you now between now and the draft? Just waiting for the draft or what?
With those guys, I mean they continue to train. That we're heavy NFL right now.
Yeah.
For the next couple of weeks, and then May is mostly college, and June is back to NFL.
So we may is that a lot of the college guys come back to
they're
train?
Done with spring ball.
Spring
they usually
ball
have
ends.
A couple weeks off, and so they'll just get an Airbnb here and chill for 2 weeks.
All right, Carson Beck has got to be sky high. He's in a great spot, great opportunity. We all think he made the right decision. He was so good at times last year.
I think he did make the right decision, but the thing that has hit me during this draft process is I think he would be the second quarterback taken.
You think he would?
I really do believe that. Just skill set, overall engine power, all that kind of stuff. But he's doing great. He's put on some weight, some really good weight, which we've been trying to do the last couple of years, find his weight. And it seems like he has settled into kind of what his new life is there because he moved off of campus. He moved out of Athens.
Right.
And so he's just getting into a routine, man.
I saw a list that surprised me that top 10 college NILs, and Carson made it. He was 10th, like 1.6 maybe or 2.1 or something.
I'm just looking at
it. You need to start charging a little more is what I'm saying.
Don't he got a Lambo or something like that?
Yeah, he got a Lambo.
He does have a Lambo.
He got a Lambo.
Be careful with those lists.
Oh, well, I'm just saying what he said. I don't know if it's right or not.
Last thing, Denny, Deion coming out with the comments about Shedeur Sanders and Travis Hunter. And I think Shedeur Sanders is a good prospect. Shedeur Sanders is interesting because he's not that athletic, I don't think. He's not like a great runner.
I mean, he's not what you would think being Deion.
Right.
Yeah,
he's not
definitely
like that.
Not that. But, I mean, athletically, be upper half. For
is he a slam dunk first round pick in your mind?
No,
not necessarily.
No, I don't think slam dunk. I think he needs to have a year.
Okay,
Travis Hunter is a different story.
Yeah. But
Shedeur, I think he needs to have a decent year to be able to do what Deion's saying. Like, I think he'd have to have a Heisman type year, which, and this is not, I love what Deion's doing. And I even love this move because he's got us talking about his kid as being the top five pick.
Sure.
But the reality of this thing is they're going to have to win more than four games.
Yes.
Like you're going to have to find a way to win 8, 9, 10 games to really, truly have a chance at this top five.
I'm just looking at this, and this is next year updated player rankings. And they have Carson Beck fourth, but they have two guys ahead of him that
quarterback?
Yeah.
They have him. Who
it is. I don't know. I just wanted to see names. So I got Shedeur Sanders one. I got the Penn State kid too. He better be a hell of a lot better. Now, he's old school NFL size, big 6'5".
I know Drew.
Okay.
Yeah.
The A&M kid, Connor Wiegman.
Yeah, we work with Connor.
Yeah. What's he like?
It's
pretty good?
Good.
Okay.
Yeah, good.
Then Beck and then Ewers. I would have Beck and Ewers like 1-2 in my world.
Yeah,
this
list is weird.
Yeah. They're all weird.
Yeah. Yeah, where is Mertz?
And by the way,
that's actually a great question.
There's some – listen, I've seen Graham Mertz in top 10 returning quarterbacks. Like
Yeah. No, no doubt.
Yeah.
No doubt. Graham Mertz draft prospects have never been higher than they are right now.
Yeah, and I ain't even thinking about
it's
that.
It's not like
I'm
a first round.
I'm thinking about Gator
but
prospects, okay?
No, yeah. No, I mean productivity. I mean, he's got to be in the top 10 coming back.
Well, it's good to see you, my man.
You too. You too.
Our friend Denny Thompson, 6 points and more. We appreciate him stopping by and hanging out. He is the quarterback whisperer. This is The Drill.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. In a world where life can be predictable.
I will give them something they've never seen before.
1010XL.
Hey sports fans, this is Hayes Carlion for QC Kinetics. This is the time of year to enjoy life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you love to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now, set up a free consultation. Call them at 904-274-5522. They've got two great locations, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra Beach. Go see them. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking lasting joint pain relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. It's a fact. QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your own body's ability to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available for you. So you can walk and run and climb stairs and play golf and move again pain-free. 904-274-5522. That's QC Kinetics. Call them today.
Hey, couldn't be any happier than to join the George Moore Chevrolet family. When I say family, I mean it. You can ask me. You can ask Denny Thompson, too. You can ask E. You can visit their beautiful showroom and find out for yourself right off Atlantic Boulevard. No pressure, just friendly help. And whether you want a car, a truck, an SUV, an electric, a pre-owned, you name it, you bet George Moore Chevrolet has it. I joined the Jacksonville truck world with a beautiful blue Silverado that I just love. If you can't make it over to Atlantic Boulevard, don't worry. Just go to morechevy.com. That's M-O-O-R-E, morechevy.com. So easy to navigate. Transparent pricing. All the vehicles, sales, service, parts. Never been more easy to use. George Moore Chevrolet gang, together, let's drive.
It's March basketball. That means a host of top teams will be competing for the NCAA title. When it comes to commercial painters, there's also some healthy competition out there. Jason Parker with Performance Painting. To help you know the right questions to ask any painter competing for your business this year, visit performancepaintingjacks.com. Or if you're ready for a friendly quote, give us a call and ask about our free pressure wash promotion for your next project. Performance Painting, quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
Did you know Prime Roofing manufactures, fabricates, and installs their metal roofs? If you're thinking about a metal roof, think Prime Roofing. Schedule an estimate today at PrimeRoofingFL.com. That's PrimeRoofingFL.com.
There's a reason. It's called Student Athlete.
Listen for the High School Scholar Athlete Wednesdays on The Frangie Show.
Brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
And the Plumbers and Pipe Fitters Local Union 234 on 1010XL.
Whether you're in need of a simple AC repair or it's time to upgrade your HVAC system, Duck Duck Air Conditioning is here to help. Give us a call today to schedule an estimate, 904-862-6769, or online at duckduckac.com.
You're shriveling up now.
Jumbo Shrimp Baseball presented by FIS opens today at 121 Financial Ballpark. Come early for the opening day street carnival and don't miss post-game fireworks. Tomorrow, the first 2,000 fans get a free t-shirt plus more fireworks. Then join us for Baptist Health Sunday Family Fun Day with a pre-game egg hunt. Tickets start at just $5, jackshrimp.com. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, affordable family fun.
Visionaries, builders, and doers, are you ready to change the world? Miller Electric is your opportunity to shape the future. Miller Electric is leading the charge in electric vehicle technology with our state-of-the-art EV Innovation Design Center. We're working to create a sustainable future. We're also the proud partners of the Jacksonville Jaguars, powering their performance at the brand-new Miller Electric Center. Miller Electric, we provide competitive pay, unbeatable benefits. Apply today. MillerCareers.com, Miller Electric, an equal opportunity employer.
Hi, I'm Kamiko, the founder of Miko's Hot Chicken. When we started our family restaurant, we were also raising a family. But let me tell you, it wasn't easy. Our Chase Inc. card was there to reward us on all of our business needs. Now we have a thriving location, and we're hungry for more.
With the Chase Inc. Business Unlimited card, you can earn unlimited 1.5% cash back on every purchase, so your business can go from here to possible. Chase for business. Make more with yours. Real business owners compensated for their participation. Cards issued by JPMorgan Chase Bank, and a member FDIC, subject to credit approval. Terms apply.
At Randy Marion Cadillac in Jacksonville, we have over 40 2024 all-electric Cadillac Lyrics in stock.
Take advantage today of two awesome incentives.
First, a $7,500 rebate applied to the purchase price directly at signing.
That's a $7,500 rebate with no need to wait for tax time.
And second, a $1,500 credit for a high-speed in-home charger.
Over $9,000 in savings.
Now's the time to drive away in luxury in a brand-new all-electric Cadillac Lyric.
Randy Marion Cadillac, Southside Boulevard, Jacksonville, plus tax tag title $899, admin fee and resist all.
Tell them Jennifer sent ya.
Winter time at the Blue Crab Crab House. You know what that means. Time for oysters. Buy them by the tray, broiled, half shell with Romano cheese, wine topping, or fried. And of course, each and every Wednesday, $1 oysters at the Blue Crab Crab House. Serving Northeast Florida since 1996. Make reservations by calling 260-CRAB. Jacksonville's best, the Blue Crab Crab House, off of San Jose on Jewington Creek Road.
Round up a foursome of friends and test your aim to help kids succeed. It's the 6th annual Clay Shoot to support the Boys and Girls Clubs of Northeast Florida and McKenzie's Camp Deep Pond. The fun happens Thursday, May 13th at Jack's Clay Target Sports. Get your team and the Boys and Girls Club take care of the rest. Ammo, cart, clays, breakfast bites, lunch, and goodies. Proceeds benefit 56 area clubs serving over 5,200 area kids every day. Go to bgcnf.org/events.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
My pastor of the street look into these deep, dark, depressed, sad, lonely eyes. That's how I feel after March Madness last night. It's North Carolina that's taking the brunt of my criticism today. Not sure how you lose to Alabama on that stage. As a number one seed, Alabama has a nice basketball program. Alabama was a good team this year. The net rankings loved them, and I guess the net rankings were more right than they were wrong. But understand this about Alabama this year. This year, when Alabama played a good team on either a neutral or an away floor, it didn't go so well. Now, they had losses.
Roll Tide!
They had losses to Purdue, Creighton, Arizona. They're all top 10 teams. Those aren't terrible losses, but they did have losses to all three. It was a 13-point loss to Arizona. They played Purdue pretty tough, actually. I lost to them 6. I think that was a game that was out here in West Florida in one of those deals, maybe, but I could be wrong on that. But they lost at Tennessee 91-71. They lost at Auburn 99-81. They lost at Kentucky 117-95. They lost at Florida 105-87. And then lost again to Florida in the SEC tournament 102-88. The tail end of the year, if they played a good team, a top 10 team, away from Tuscaloosa, they didn't just lose, they got hammered. So to beat number one in North Carolina tonight, really, really shocking. It was a very unfortunate night for R.J. Davis, who's a really good player, who's Carolina's leader, and he was just terrible last night. And that in-game execution by R.J. Davis will very much deserve to be questioned. If you're having a – Dan, I understand being the alpha.
Mm-hmm.
If you're having a night where you're 4 for 19 and 0 for 9 from 3 at that point, maybe don't insist on taking the last shot. You're 4 for 19. You're 0 for 9 from 3. At some point, even as the alpha dog, maybe it's not my night. Let me get it to Ingram or Baycott or Cadeau or someone.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a mistake. I get it, what you're trying to do. And he's the best player on the team.
Yeah.
And he's the guy all year. He's the guy all year long.
He had a couple kids who were stepping up, making shots, and
he forced it.
He tried.
He forced.
He did. Yeah. And he was getting to the free throw line, which is good. You know, they're doing my
theory. 8 for 9 there. Yeah.
You do my theory, you drive to the basket, you get contact, you get fouled. And
they're calling that more than ever this tournament.
Oh, it drives me
nuts. Get in the air, they're giving it to you.
But with that said, Alabama played really good defense on him at the end, and he couldn't. Yeah, he had to throw one up. And
well, at the end of the day, he was 4 for 20.
Was he 0 for from behind the arc?
0 for 9.
Yeah. I mean,
that's what killed Arizona last night. They just couldn't hit a three.
Oh, man. They could not.
Clank. And Arizona came back,
yeah.
And they got that lead.
They had a chance.
And I thought it was done.
Yeah, they had a chance. They were late. They were down 3 with the ball. But they were hurrying, too. They were playing panicky instead of just going to the bat. It was still 4 or 5 minutes to go.
And Clemson did. I have to give Clemson credit. They drew up 2 plays, like 2 dunks underneath the basket late in the game.
I was like, you cannot be this dumb, Arizona. You know
they
he's drawing up a play.
Arizona,
you know when you draw up a play, the play is to someone to go to the basket with a back cut. And sure enough, they did it over and over again, easy buckets.
It is I'll give you a tried and true now. Don't take it from me. I'm going to lose the wheel bet, so I'll be spinning for my March Madness inadequacies.
Uh-huh.
But let me tell you something right now. Let me tell you something never, ever, ever do again.
Okay.
Don't ride Arizona in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, I know.
Their reputation, their bark is way much bigger than their bite. They are always a 1 or a 2. They never go anywhere. They had one miraculous run with Sean Elliott, which has now been 30 years ago almost.
I'll tell you what annoyed
Arizona
me.
Arizona is more known. They're like the Purdue of the West, bro. You put Arizona in a bracket, and they are going to disappoint. You ready? They've now lost to a team seeded at least 4 spots below them in their last 6 NCAA tournament appearances. It's as long as the mini streak since seeding began.
Yeah. Yeah. I have a quick little pop quiz for you.
Okay.
I enjoy these.
Okay.
Since the start of 2019, I want you to tell me.
Since when?
Start of 2019, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 5 years. I want you to give me the top five home run guys. Most home runs in the last 5 years. Top five.
Okay.
In the last 5 years, the top five guys, you would not get number 6. I'm going to give you number 6. It's Eugenio Suarez.
Eugenio.
We actually, he's the one that's at the Mariners, from the Reds to the Mariners.
I think we
talked about him last year and just how he's the one.
He doesn't fit.
Yeah, he's the one that you wouldn't get.
Top five home run guys last 5 years.
Well, your boy's going to be on there.
Peter My boy's Alonso. Number one.
Yeah.
192.
All right. This is a really good question. This is a hard one. I mean, I have to think Judge. He had the 60 home run year. He was almost 40 last year, even missing time.
Judge is number 3.
Okay.
174.
In 5 years, once you got to average 30 a year, huh?
Yeah, 192 to 149 are the numbers.
What about to 140? I mean,
it really, honestly, like you say, it's a tough one, but it really is to me. If you think about it, it would be like the top five home run guys, unless I'm forgetting somebody, which I could be. But to me, it's like if I think about it, if you said to me, Hick, who are the best home run hitters in baseball? I might name these five. I might.
Well, Matt Olson then is
second, 177.
I'm not surprised. I knew he had the huge year last year.
Yeah.
I didn't. Okay. I mean, I think Schwarber hits a lot of home runs.
174.
So he's on
tied
there.
Tied with Judge.
Okay, so I've got them all but one.
All but one.
And it's the number 5 guy.
Number 5 guy.
Is it? See, I want to say Trout, but he's hurt all the time. And I want to say Shohei, but I'm not sure he's been in the league long enough. And I don't know if he's been that. I know he had 40 some last year.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I'll go Mookie Betts.
Mookie Betts is a really good guess. 143. You said it. It's Shohei.
It's Shohei.
Shohei's a better home run hitter than Betts, so I would go with Shohei.
But the problem is with the pitching and the
yeah, I get it. I get it. But
So Betts is six?
Betts is seventh.
Okay.
Suarez is six.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Betts is seventh. Devers is eighth. Muncy is ninth. And Semien is 10th.
It's also hard to remember because there's some guys I thought about were Juan Soto, Austin Riley. You don't know how long they've been doing it. You know, Acuna. Yeah. But again,
I said to you the top five home run hitters, it's got to be Alonzo, Judge, Schwarber, Otani, and then you're a little surprised by Olson. But if you follow Olson's career,
well, and Olson led
consistent.
The league last year by seven.
Yeah,
I mean by a lot. So,
but he's very consistent too.
I did okay there. Yeah, I tell you, another guy who's probably higher than you would think is Ozuna.
Yeah. Yeah.
Bryce Harper is he on there?
Bryce Harper not on there.
He's been hurt too. That's another guy missed a lot of time.
Yeah, he's been hurt. So,
well, I'm excited that the Braves finally get to take the field today. It's hard on opening day. It's easy to get pessimistic after your first game because you're always playing such a good pitcher. So what a pitching matchup this will be. Strider against Wheeler in our game, and Strider had I think he was 0-0-0 ERA in the spring. Pitched great in the spring. He's added a curveball to his arsenal. So. We shall see. What that tells me is that's a more opportunity now to snap off that Tommy John ligament and miss 2 years. That's what quote learning a curveball means to me as a paranoid baseball fan.
Yeah. Yeah, I get it. I have a funny E, we got one for the culture coming up.
Oh yeah?
It's a classic.
Okay.
You're gonna play it when we come back. I've gotta let them do it.
Okay.
I can't do it, okay. But it's fun. I like it, and if people take offense, so be it.
Well,
me and E don't.
I love it. Yeah. I'm gonna.
No, you won't either.
This is the drill.
One for the culture.
It's a Green for Life Friday. Trust them for all your commercial roll-off needs.
The drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
When it's time to saddle your horse and hitch your wagon, ride with the Franchi Show.
Let's ride.
Yeah. Afternoons on 1010XL.
Let's ride!
Yeehaw!
Whoa, Archie!
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
There are only a few things the government does well, and processing passports is not one of them. Hello, it's Congressman Aaron Bean, and taking care of constituents in Northeast Florida is a top priority. If you need help with that passport, the VA, Social Security, or any federal agency, call my office, 904-557-9550, or visit bean.house.gov. I'm Congressman Aaron Bean, and serving you is what we do. Paid for by official funds authorized by the House of Representatives.
A lot of companies will tell you they're the best. At Custom Tree Surgeons, they show you every time. Custom Tree Surgeons has built an all-pro team. Every tree service professional has years of experience, continually trained and certified. They know what, when, and how to handle any job. It gets done efficiently and quickly by a team of experts. So for tree trimming, removal, stump grinding, and emergency services, forget any name other than Custom Tree Surgeons. There is no job they can't do better. Go to website CustomTreeSurgeons.com. That's CustomTreeSurgeons.com. And let them show you how the job is supposed to get done.
You
E to the T here, and if you're still in the market for a sports book to call home, bet that nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is your one-stop shop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with that Vegas life experience right from that cellular device of yours, my boy. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the website. Sign up now and take advantage of the generous welcome bonus on your first deposit all the way up to $1,000. Put in two, get back three. Ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun don't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you decide where to put that cash at. And the best part about MyBookie, you can bet anything, anytime, anywhere. And don't forget that promo code 1010XL. Come on, somebody.
NFL.
Jaguars today from the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios.
Everything you need to know about your hometown team. Jaguars today, every weekday from 10 to noon on 1010XL.
Hello, First Coast. I'm sure by now you have seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We're an industry leader in solid waste and would love the opportunity to earn your business. We're committed to customer service, reliability, and have an unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today from GFL, green for life.
The Wing Madness menu at Boston's Restaurant and Sports Bar is a slam dunk. Sink your teeth into our mouth-watering rib or cauliflower wings, available in 16 amazing flavors. Try their trash can nachos, layers of crispy tortilla chips piled high with all the fixings, and their flavorful, addictive corn wings. You'll be hoarding these like a sneaky technical foul. Get 50% off bone-in or boneless wings on our loyalty program. All the details and restrictions at Boston's.com today.
Pross, I'm thinking about changing my name.
Again? You're already the media mogul, the straw that stirs the drink, the Duke of Pablo Bay. Now what?
Refer to me as Dreamfinders Danny Hicken.
What in the blazes? Is this a cash grab?
No, it's just that I believe so much in Dreamfinders Homes. 20 locations in Northeast Florida, official home builder of Jags and Gators. Great opportunity for first-time homeowners.
All right. Dreamfinders Danny it is.
Did I mention the lowest interest rates you can find? Visit DreamfindersHomes.com. Now let Dreamfinders Danny celebrate through the majesty of song. Dream Finders,
oh,
I believe they will build your home just right.
Hi, I'm Sean Monahan from Monahan Jewelers in Atlantic Beach. Since 1977, we've been Jacksonville's local family jeweler with a beautiful selection of fine jewelry and certified diamonds. But we're also Jacksonville's leading buyer of gold and silver and diamonds from the public. Gold has recently hit an all-time high at over $2,100 per ounce and hasn't been at this level in 13 years. Pay bills, buy something fun. Now is the time to sell your gold for cash and get top dollar at Monahan Jewelers in Atlantic Beach or book online at MonahanJewelry.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Hey, can I give you a forgotten name from the sport of women's basketball? How quickly we forget.
Yeah, we're about to get one for the culture.
Yeah.
Go ahead. What do you got?
Paige Beckers. Remember her?
Yeah. Heck of a player. Welcome back. 8:53 on the program. We like to meld cultures around here.
I just saw a picture on social media there with OBJ and his mother. That seems like a strange evening.
That's a little weird.
That's
man.
Not what we're going with.
I know, but I'm just saying. Y'all want to just Google that, you'll know what I'm saying.
But this is about my New York Knickerbockers and Jalen Brunson and Josh Hart, a couple of the Nova boys. They do a podcast, and they had Isaiah Hartenstein.
Hartenstein is redheaded teammate of them.
It's weird because
he's Iowa State.
The way he says his name is Hartenstein.
Oh, he does? Well, yeah. I'll go with him then.
But anyway, he was on, and Jalen Brunson and Josh Hart were questioning him and his ethnicity, and here's a little clip, and we'll get...
This is, by the way, one of the biggest shockers, Shazam shockers you'll ever have. If you know who Isaiah Hartenstein is, if you can picture him, he's he's a big, tall, like redheaded dude from Iowa State, I think.
Hartenstein.
Hartenstein. That enough tells you right there, okay? Here we go. Listen to the pod.
No, that's great. Let's just jump right into it. Are you black?
I really wanted to cover that. I'm actually happy about this. Explain your blackness. Well, level of blackness.
Uh-huh. So my level of blackness, I mean, I put
You know, it's like light skin. I'm bright skin.
Ooh. So, ooh, like, okay, above. Bright skin. I like that.
I'm above.
My child's bright skin.
I'm above light skin. No, but yeah, my dad's black. Anytime people find out, y'all know Kim Peele, the show.
Yeah.
So you know, like when Barack Obama's going in, white man handshake different. Black.
Mm-hmm.
When they find out I'm black.
You got the good handshake.
It changes. The whole vibe changes. It goes from, hey, Zay, how you doing? Zay, hey, yo, Zay, what up, man? So the whole vibe changes.
They were giving you one of these before, the straight hand?
No, it's like, it's really like the, I think Hart did the same thing.
Yeah, he's like, oh, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah,
pleasure to meet you.
You know I'm black? It changes. Like, oh, Zay.
Yeah, I found out he was black. I was like, yo, that's great.
I mean, he doesn't look a bit black.
Not an ounce.
He was born in Eugene, Oregon. His father, Florian Hartenstein, is a German-American basketball coach, former professional basketball player of mixed African-American heritage. Isaiah's mother is American. Parents met in the United States. Father attended and played for Oregon. I don't think Hartenstein went to college.
Oh, he didn't? Boy, he feels like an Iowa State player to me.
Yeah, he was drafted in the second round, went to the Artland Dragons, the Zalgiris Rio Grande Valley Vipers, the Rockets 18-20, the Nuggets 20-21, the Cavs 21, the Clippers 22, and the Knicks the last couple years. He was the NBA G League champion in 19 and the G League Finals MVP in 19. He's a great rebounder. He's just a big body and he plays well. He signed a 2-year $16 million contract with the Knicks. He's a good basketball player. Anyway.
But you would never, ever, ever
categorize
him or think of him as a black man.
No. And it was, but it's funny. And that's, I enjoyed that. And that's one for the culture. Your thoughts, Manuel?
What's up?
Your thoughts.
My bad. I was looking for something.
That's okay.
Yeah. He don't look like a brother, but like he said, yeah, he's a bright skinned brother. So, hey, what's happening? Yeah. What's happening?
Family.
You heard, he's talked about the light skinned brother. Now we got a bright skinned brother.
Bright skin.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So anyway, that was good. And the, Knicks are...
he's actually a decent little complimentary player.
He's, you know, a really
good... He's not going to be a scorer and a rebounder. He's just going to give you like a little
when
you know,
Mitch Robinson,
get you 8-6.
When Mitch Robinson went out with injury, that dude was racking up 15, 18 rebounds a night.
2 years, $16 million, man. Yeah. The NBA is the place to be if you can be there.
Be
and by the
money.
Way, he's underpaid. He'll get more.
By the way, he makes more than like what the top running backs went and got in free agency.
Yeah,
think about
point.
That. Isaiah Hartenstein.
Hartenstein.
A bright-skinned brother.
Yes, he is a bright-skinned brother.
Philly going down to yellow and brown. That's what's in.
Oh, my God. Those Padre guys. Oh, so bad. So bad, the Padre guy. All right, it's time for my I can't stand it. It's manifesting itself within me today. I am over this flipping Houston Texan love parade that I just keep watching go by me this offseason.
We got a long way to go, so get ready.
I can't
them again.
No, my pest is not going to be Houston. It's not their fault, but my goodness. In this case, it's a CBS writer, Jordan Dejani. Pest today brought to you by Mission Pest Solutions. That's what you get for all your pest problems when you turn to Mission Pest Solutions. Call 944-PEST. You'll speak to a locally and veteran-owned organization who will be there, Johnny, on the spot. Terrific customer service. In fact, read all the Google reviews. And, by the way, when you call Mission Pest Solutions, 944-PEST, get your first initial pest and termite treatment. They're going to give you 50% off just for listening to 1010XL. That's Mission Pest Solutions. Okay. Jordan Dejani has ranked the AFC teams just to see who is capable of knocking off the Chiefs and keeping them from a three-peat.
Okay.
So, boys, after Kansas City, who would you consider the top competition in the AFC to the Chiefs? And just in our thinking.
Baltimore.
Baltimore's fine, and Buffalo is also fine. Mm-hmm. They do have Baltimore number two. They have Buffalo number six. So mm-hmm. This guy, you can tell his stupidity rings true right off the spot. Give me some more legitimate competitors. If the Chiefs don't go to the Super Bowl, Baltimore and Buffalo are certainly two. The team that I think the best team in the AFC outside of the Chiefs is one that can't keep its quarterback healthy. I think it's the Bengals. I think if the Bengals have Joe Burrow, they're the second best team. They've been to a Super Bowl. They've been to another conference championship game. So I would certainly put Cincinnati up there. They're number four on this list. Anybody else jump out? Are those
Miami?
It for the legit? You think Miami could be?
Yeah,
he's biased on that. He likes
Miami. Got Miami number seven, right? anybody else. Like, as much as I want to think the Jags, the last year stepped backward, I don't feel like they're a Super Bowl contender this year.
No.
They have to earn their way back into that. So, and I think Houston is kind of like what Jacksonville was last year. They're arrow pointed up, right? They're far from a perfect football team. They went on that playoff loss at Baltimore. They were terrible. C.J. Stroud was awful. Single-digit completions, couple interceptions. Don't get me wrong. But here they are, CBS Sports, ranking the teams most legitimately able to stop Kansas City's three-peat. So number one is the Ravens. Number two on the list, the second-best team other than Kansas City, according to CBS, the Houston Texans. That's asinine. It's asinine. They went 10-7. They lost much worse than the Jags did at Kansas City to Baltimore in round two. And so this notion that C.J. Stroud is Mahomes and that the Texans are some unbeatable, about to dominate, it's annoying the stew out of me.
On the fly producing here, we should have puck talk today. Should we do it? Should we dial up coach or should we come back and do it?
I'll come back and do it.
Oh, well, then let's do it. It's 9 o'clock nasty, though. He's got to be a part of that then.
Well, I'm going to sit that one out then.
Okay.
This is The Drill. It's a GFL Friday.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Get Florida Gators play-by-play on 1010XL.
It's a weekend of Easter baseball in the swamp. Florida, Mississippi State. Friday night, Saturday night, and Sunday at 1 on 1010 AM.
Hey, stop paying for exterior paint that does not protect your home or your business. Start paying for Rhino Shield and their beautiful, durable coatings. They never chip, crack, or peel. Never! And by the way, here's a 25-year warranty. Nobody else does that. It prevents unsightly mold, mildew, and algae. No water intrusion damage from nasty weather. So if you need to get your house or your small business or your business painted, man, Rhino Shield is the way to go. It saves you thousands compared to the cost of repainting over and over again. And right now, gang, they have 0% financing. They got great low pricing, 20% off in some areas. It's never been easier to paint your home with Rhino Shield. So you say, Hick, what do I do? I'll tell you. Go to RhinoShieldJax.com. RhinoShieldJax.com. Get that free estimate today. You'll thank us later.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Did you hear what's happening? Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet are spring cleaning. New inventory on the ground means we need to make more room. Take advantage of huge savings on thousands of vehicles priced to sell. New and pre-owned prices have been reduced, and all sales associates have been instructed to give maximum value on all trades. But you better hurry. The best deals go first. Head to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine. Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville to take advantage of our spring cleaning sale. We're here to wow you.
Break free from the old school hassle at All Pro Roofing. They've revolutionized the game. And guess what? No more pressure, hassle, or time meeting with someone face-to-face for a roof quote. Unlock the power of an instant roof quote right from the comfort of your home. Get the information you need when you need it. Explore your roofing options today. Head over to allproroofingllc.com. Hit that instant roof quote tab for a free instant roof quote. Allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132702.
CDC 060138.
Get ready for an unforgettable musical journey with the incredible Claire Vandiver at Players Grill Mandarin. Influenced by indie rock to modern pop, Claire's unique sound is a breath of fresh air. Come listen to Claire Vandiver Friday, March 29th at 8 p.m. Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
Home of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
I'm here with Danny Van Sickle, director of the Electrical Training Alliance. Danny, tell me about your program.
Hey, Rick. We're a five-year electrical apprenticeship. Our students start out making over $40,000 a year, and right now graduate making over $90,000 a year, including benefits. There is no tuition or no student debt. You just have to apply and get accepted.
Did you say no tuition and no student debt?
You heard that right, Rick. Once you're accepted to the program, your only costs are the books and the course fees, about $800 a year.
That sounds like an amazing opportunity. How can I learn more?
Just go to etajax.org, and you can apply there.
Apply by May 23rd.
Barrett.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit republicservices.com.
Equal opportunity employer.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's lucky contestant, a cheese negotiator from Jacksonville, Florida, meet Margaret Drent.
How do you like my costume, Bob? I'm Gruyere.
Well, you smell great, Margaret. But here's your question. What's wrong with your air conditioner when you hear this sound?
That's a toughie. Are you sure you don't want me to tell you the suggested retail price of a box of Rice-A-Roni?
5 seconds, Margaret.
Is it a compressor motor starter failure?
That's right, Margaret. And if you call the coolness experts at Mueller Air Conditioning, we can fix that faulty AC to make sure that
you are cool.
Surprisingly stuffy inside a giant cheese.
You signed the waiver, Margaret.
Stay cooler with Mueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
This is former NFL quarterback David Garrard. If your knees have taken a beating and you're finally ready to do something about it, then let Southeast Orthopedic take a look. Come on, do your knees a favor.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
David Garrard here. I've had the PRP treatment from Southeast Orthopedic Specialists, and my knees are really doing well. Platelet-rich plasma treatment may be the answer for whatever is hurting you.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
It's time, basketball bettors, March Mania. I'm here to tell you about BetUS.com. I endorse one sportsbook and casino, that's BetUS. They've been driving the basket for 30 years. This year, BetUS has an epic three-pointer for you. 125% sign-up bonus on your first three deposits. I said it. 125% sign-up bonus, first three deposits, plus 10% gambler's insurance. Get started. Visit BetUS.com or give them a call. 1-800-MY-BETUS. That's 1-800-MY-BETUS. BetUS, where the game begins.
The Guess Who, rockin' Jacksonville, Thursday, April 11th.
American Woman!
Catch the Canadian Hitmakers live at Florida Theater.
No sugar tonight, but coffee.
Rock legends The Guess Who's long-awaited return to Jacksonville. Get your tickets now at Florida Theater Box Office or floridatheater.com.
No time left for you.
Don't miss a night of legendary rock classics with The Guess Who. Thursday, April 11th at Florida Theater. Produced by Elko Concerts.
If you owe the IRS and can't pay, now is the time to call J. David Tax Law. After a two-year hiatus, the IRS has resumed their aggressive collections letters. Don't wait. Call J. David Tax Law or visit jdavidtaxlaw.com.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, sponsored by J. David Tax Law. Tariq Sapp is heading into his fourth season as a Florida Gator defensive lineman, and following the spring camp scrimmage, was upbeat about the newcomers and new staff.
I'm loving the young guys. I'm loving the new addition of coaches. I just feel like everybody's kind of hungry and push forward and take the next step.
There were some defensive standouts at the Knowles scrimmage yesterday. They caught the attention of head coach Mike Norvell.
You know, I know Pat had an early sack, and you saw Darryl Jackson definitely flat. I saw Marvin Jones, Sione, Tony Miller, all those guys, you know, thought had good moments.
In the East Coast Hockey League, despite the Orlando Solo Bears fighting for a playoff spot, our Jacksonville Icemen were able to hold them off and secure another victory. The Icemen will next face the Florida Everblades this evening. Puck drops at 7 p.m. And that's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Sam Nelson.
Currently it's 9:08 and it's 54 degrees. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
Tone 10XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
As they say in hockey, let's do that hockey.
Let's do that hockey thing, and let's do it right now with Nick Lucco, the head coach of the Icemen. The man who is leading us to greatness, the man who can sew up a playoff berth this weekend if some things go right, I believe. Is that correct, Coach Luco? Are you aware of that?
I think it would have to be next week if everything goes well.
Oh, it's so close. Yeah,
we're close, yeah.
How many games do we have left? Can you answer that question, Nick Luco?
We're down to 8.
8 games left, and then the quest for the Kelly Cup begins. Coach, do we need 16 playoff victories to secure the Kelly Cup, or is it more than that?
That's correct.
16.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a grind. Oh, what a grind.
Sweet 16.
Coach, it's amazing. And again, we've talked about the divisions, the conferences. It doesn't matter. I mean, it is just a – it is a battle galore.
These playoffs are going to be fantastic.
Oh, man. Yeah. I mean
– there's going to be some good games because we've talked about the South is just – I mean, there's
– Coach, why is it –
good team.
Why is it like in hockey – more than any, first off, hockey playoffs, if you're not a hockey fan, you should watch hockey playoffs. They're unbelievable. And it appears they're unbelievable at any level. But is there any theory as to why? Like, I mean, in NFL and baseball, usually your top seed's not going to get beat in the first round. I mean, that can happen in hockey, and it does so all the time. I think about the Panthers beating the Bruins last year. I mean, it's just incredible to me. Is there any theories on that, or were just all so evenly matched? What are your thoughts?
Yeah, I think you're right. I think it's everyone's very evenly matched. I think in the NHL, you know, with the salary cap, it's pretty tight all the time. So I don't know if there's a theory to it, but it makes it for exciting playoffs.
So how do you balance pushing the squad here over the last 8, and then you got another 16 to go at least, obviously more than that. I don't think you're going to go 4-4-4-4, but if you do, that'd be fine. How do you balance that those two things here now as we are in the home stretch?
Yeah, I think it's just day by day, game by game. You're kind of focusing on the next game and trying to take care of business.
Coach, you talked about when we talked last week. I can't remember if you told me it was 4 or 5. Was it forwards? Have you seen get called up? When you get to the playoffs, does the organization change its tact, or are you still going to be balancing that delicate, tightrope of knowing exactly what your personnel will be once we get to the postseason?
Yeah. Well, we've gotten 3 guys back since Saturday. Good. So, we've always liked our depth the entire year. And when those guys were up, the guys that were here are playing really well. And now that we have them back, it just adds to our depth.
And you had a nice W last night, right?
Yeah, it was a big one in Orlando. So down here in Fort Myers tonight, and got to do a job.
Yeah, all the way down to Fort Myers. So let's go get them. Let's get some dubs, and let's finish strong. And then we look forward to the playoffs. That's when the big dogs come out, man. I can't wait. So congrats on everything so far. Keep it rolling, and we'll catch up with you next week, Coach.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thanks, guys. Talk
all right.
to you soon.
There he goes, right, Nick Luco. He's on the road.
You know, the Chiefs have won 2 straight Super Bowls.
Mm-hmm.
They've been the most successful team in the NFL over the past, 5 or 6 years.
Okay.
But, yeah, it's still hard to keep everyone happy. You know, when the NFLPA listed those team report cards, remember back at the end of February?
Yeah, awful.
Yeah, the Chiefs
were last, 31st.
Yeah, ranked at the bottom of the pile. They were given a D or an F in 6 of the report card's 11 categories.
Mm-hmm.
The second lowest overall grade of any team in the NFL, ahead of only Washington. We know what a terrible, terrible situation that's been. According to the survey, the players were told that the locker room would be renovated following 2022, but that renovation never came. The players were clearly unhappy. They also gave an F to Clark Hunt, who graded out as the worst owner in the NFL. Well, guess who is finally learning this?
Who?
Clark Hunt. Hunt finally had a chance to defend himself over the locker room grade this week, and according to the owner, he never promised the players the locker room would be getting a renovation. I've spoken to some of our vets about that, and they confirmed to me it was a miscommunication. Certainly, I personally never said anything to them about a renovation of the locker room. It was a misunderstanding.
Well, let me tell you something. You cheap so-and-so, you ought to renovate the locker 100%. Room. You got the Super Bowl champions there. That ought to not be one of the worst locker rooms in the NFL.
Yeah.
I know that they also came out and already have made threats to the city, like, well, if we don't get what we want new stadium-wise, they want to move. They want a new stadium, I think.
In town, but yeah.
But they're one of the options is certainly leaving Kansas City. Bleep you, buddy.
Yeah.
I mean, that stuff like that. You know, the Hunt family.
They've given their fan base 3 Super Bowls, Dan. I mean.
Yeah. Because they stumbled into Patrick Mahomes and Andy Reid.
I don't know, man. I'm a fan. I can't say bleep you to a dude that's won me three of the last five Super Bowls.
Don't be a cheapskate, owner. Set it up.
Based on the grades, the players seem to dislike a lot about the overall situation in Kansas City. What's odd about this, this usually goes hand-in-hand with losing teams. This is understandable with the Commanders.
Yeah.
Usually winning will, you know, cleanse the palate a little bit. That's what was surprising about this. Andy Reid was given an A-plus for his coaching, and they still were second from the bottom. They got a C or worse in all of the 10 other categories. Mm-hmm. They got an F in ownership, locker room, nutritionist, dietitian, and training camp.
Mm-hmm.
And to your point, I mean, if you're Hunt, I mean, don't you have to, you know, shouldn't you be doing the locker room? Come on.
Yes.
Got a championship-winning team here. How about this? Take $30,000 off the price of each ring. They'll never know the difference. Get lab diamonds. Who'll never know?
I'll tell you this, and I've always liked this and respected that you, whether you like him or hate him, I think Mark Cuban is like a first-class owner. And I can remember reading things about Mark Cuban and what he did down in Dallas in terms of what he did for his players.
I like him fine. I don't have any problems. You just mean in general. Yeah, I'm just saying.
I think that, you know, what he does for his players is first class all the way, and it makes people want to play there. Now, they did get one world championship, so it worked, but it's not easy. You know, they made a bad basketball decision letting Jalen Brunson go, but it is what it is. So, God, you would have thought Jalen Brunson would be a perfect fit with Luka too.
They were. He was a perfect fit, dude.
That was a big mistake.
He would have taken less, and they wouldn't pay him. They could have got him for like $90 million or something, or 60. It's just terrible, terrible management. They would have a better chance with Jalen Brunson than Kyrie Irving. I believe that. Mm-hmm. Although, as we talked about yesterday, I think off the air, Kyrie's decided to ball again. He
did.
He's balling again, yeah. Kyrie. He's decided he wants to play for a while.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
That'll probably serve the match. This has been an odd NBA season. Teams get super hot. We've had a year where one of six or eight teams will win 10, 11, 12 in a row. The Rockets are on that stretch right now. Don't look now. Boy, the Pistons look worse and worse, don't they? Here are the Rockets and the Thunder, who were kind of along with Detroit at the bottom of the barrel for 2, 3, 4 years in a row. And those other guys have corrected. They've drafted the right guys. They put together good teams. And now they're going to be, you know, potential playoff teams for years to come, and there's Detroit up there still sitting on 10, 11, 12 wins, man.
Well, it's like, I feel like, and tell me if I'm wrong here, but I feel like the Magic have sort of done that.
Yeah, that's another one.
I feel like the Magic have hit on some draft picks, right? You know, from Banchero to Suggs to Cole Anthony to Wagner, right? Those guys are all pretty good, right?
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Suggs is kind
starting
of
to come on, though.
Yeah, he's starting to come on.
How's Anthony?
Banchero from the get-go has been great.
How's Anthony Black?
I haven't seen much of him.
Okay. I don't know much about him.
No, I haven't. I've watched the Magic some. It's you hit the names that stand out to me every time I watch
them. Those are all draft picks.
Right.
And when you draft 5th, 8th, 1st, 6th, those are the guys you got to hit on, right?
Yeah.
So
college basketball news is going to start to break here over the course of the next few days. People are going to hit in the transfer portal. Players are going in. If you miss it, Riley Kugel's gone in. According to Cougs, he's got offers from the big boys in college basketball.
100% the big boys.
So we'll see where he ends up. I don't think Florida will miss him. It just wasn't a good fit, as it turns out, even though he was the first high school recruit for Todd Golden. John Calipari, you know, the word has been that, you know, he probably needs to play the transfer portal a little more, the transfer portal game. Well, they're in the transfer portal game, but going in the wrong direction. Sophomore guard Adu Thiero has announced he's headed into the portal. Here's the irony. He wasn't a real high recruit. He was a lightly regarded recruit, but he emerged as a starter last year, a physical player, 6'8". He's going to help someone. I read an article yesterday on Todd Golden in the transfer portal, and the word seems to be, based on the Gators' improvement, Golden's work with the guys he's brought in through the portal.
You get a reputation.
He's getting a reputation, He's getting the Mike Norvell reputation. So the thought is, if there's a guy in the portal, the Gators are in on him.
Well,
that's a good place to be.
Washington transfer Corin Johnson, Pac-12 Sixth Man of the Year. Kind of an option to replace Zion Pullen. He's got his final five. Indiana, Oregon, UCLA, and Florida.
Right. And there are others. They've got a player of the year from... they got a couple guys from Virginia Tech. There's a guy at Richmond. Where is that? Where Will Richard came from? Richmond,
Rich, right? What?
Rich Mullen.
Okay.
They got a guy there. There's another kid they really like. He's like the MAC player of the year or something.
Okay.
There's another kid in Florida, or he's from Florida. He played for a small school. He's a smaller guard. So bottom line is, it looks like Todd Golden's going to have kind of his pickup. Well, I don't want to say that.
Yeah, I don't think he's going
to. And here's the deal, though. Here's why college basketball is coming together. These big wig elitists, Dan, don't think they need to do it. They don't aggressively go out and scour and get five good transfers. They may sprinkle one in, but they're going to ride with their McDonald All-American one-and-done type talent. So it's leaving the Floridas and that second-level program, and there's a bunch of them. It's leaving them to go fortify their rosters the way that may be more proven nowadays.
Our Dreamfinders Homes poll question of the day was Trevor Lawrence going into year four, expectations for him. The overwhelming winner here with just a few minutes to go, 30 touchdowns, AFC playoffs, 70%.
That's where I would be.
And so that tells you, kind of gives you an idea where people are with Trevor. So,
which, by the way, 30 touchdowns playoffs.
Heck of a year.
It's a hell of a good place to be as a franchise.
Oh, yeah.
Especially compared to where some of the places we've been.
Yeah. And the least picked one is, interesting enough, 4,000 yards, 9-8 again. So.
Well, that's, you know. Again, we don't care much that the team that literally had won the fewest games in the entire league in 5 years has now produced a couple 500 seasons in three. I mean, that's kind of, you know.
Oh, man.
What's wrong?
We lost a great one.
Who?
Great actor. Louis Gossett Jr. has passed away. 87 years.
Okay.
I like Louis Gossett Jr., an officer and gentleman, won an Oscar, I think, for it. He was terrific. In a bunch of great, great things.
Louis Gossett Jr. played right off the officer and gentleman that went right into Iron Eagle. Remember that?
Yeah.
Military thing's working. Let's do another one.
Yeah. Won an Academy Award for an officer and a gentleman.
Unbelievable. That was a good movie.
That was a very good movie.
Like, the drama. Yeah, that's that one.
He was a big part of the Root series, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, he spanned a lot of years, man, in acting. He was a Broadway star as well, so pretty good stuff, man. Pretty good stuff. Was in movies in the 60s. I mean, Louis Gossett Jr.'s. E, do you know who Louis Gossett Jr. is?
The name is familiar.
Yeah, you don't have much of a movie guy, so. Wow, I didn't know this. In August of 1969, Gossett was with members of the Mamas and the Papas. They were invited to actor Sharon Tate's house. He headed home first to shower and change clothes. As he was getting ready to leave, he caught a news flash about Tate's murder. That was the night that Charles Manson went over there.
Ooh.
How about that?
Ooh.
There had to be a reason for me.
In life, sometimes the best decisions you make are the ones you don't.
Yeah. Oof. Yeah, won a Golden Globe for that as well. And you're right, he went into... Iron Eagle. Louis Gossett Jr.
I'm guessing that Officer and a Gentleman were teenagers, or am I a teenager yet? Is that like early 80s, Officer and a Gentleman?
I would think so.
81, yeah. 82, something like that. He was a badass.
Oh, yeah.
Louis Gossett Jr.
82.
Yeah, he was a bad man in that movie. And it was a good movie. Again,
mayonnaise got after it, man.
Mayonnaise.
Got after it.
Yeah, it was good. And then that one, like, that serves everyone. Like, a woman liked the movie, men liked the movie. It's got a lot.
Opening day in baseball yesterday, umpires clearly in midseason form with blown calls, including a one that could have been very costly for the Texas Rangers, but Travis Jankowski, of all people, hits a tying pinch hit home run in the bottom of the ninth, and the Rangers beat the Cubs at extra innings. Some other good the Diamondbacks, I think, scored 12 runs in the
14.
Third. 14 runs in one inning.
Yeah, most ever.
The Yankees got a Soto assist from the outfield.
Yeah, they made more of that than it was, but it was a good throw. It was a good throw on the money, and it kept the tying run from scoring. It was reviewed, which, again, review in the Major League Baseball is 99.9%, it seems like, going to be what they called.
Mike Trout hit a home run in his first at bat of the year. And then
Mike Trout's got to get the hell out of there, man. Get
That's
out,
a bad
bro.
Team. Ronnie,
get out.
Ronnie Washington's going to have a tough year
there. No, and Ron Washington took the Rangers to the World Series back-to-back years. So, yeah.
He's in a bad spot on that.
Trout doesn't get enough credit for just staying. He's never thrown a fit, never demanded to leave. And they, but in fairness also to the Angels, they've tried. It's just never worked. I mean, they have tried. They've gone and bought elite talent. They've gotten the best managers they can find, and they just nothing seems to work. I enjoyed the Oakland, the A's fans protesting there, so everyone that bought a ticket and showed up instead just stayed in the parking lot, and the A's played in the friendly caverns of the Coliseum. Marlins blew a game. Nice job, E. They blew a game late.
Yeah,
they had
E,
a lead.
What about that? You can bring that up the whole day.
I was trying to avoid it, man. We lost 5-4.
Yeah,
Pirates. 6-5, I believe.
Pirates.
1 point.
Pirates came from behind to win there.
Yeah, nice job, E.
You're welcome.
Mike Trout did homer in his first at bat, and then the Orioles unleashed. Corbin Burns, the first guy on opening day to have at least 11 strikeouts and give up one or fewer hits in like a century. So that's a big addition for them. The Orioles could win the AL.
Damn, E, you're up 5-2 and you blew
it. Yeah, they blew the game. I was watching some of that one.
Good to see the Marlins got another stellar bullpen there trotting out there.
And that was a storyline last year.
Is that Sixto Sanchez coming out of the bullpen blowing that save? Wasn't he the fat guy we saw in spring training?
I don't know.
Pretty sure that was him.
By the way, the MVP3 did their job for the dream team out there, the Billionaires Club. It was Betts homered, Freeman homered, Ohtani got on base 3 times, and Glasnow looked a lot better than he did his first outing.
Oof. Glasnow wasn't bad. It was the Yamamoto guy who was terrible in the first outing.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so a lot of good stuff going on. We'll get into it today because the Mets go and the Braves go.
Yeah,
so
we're
weekend baseball.
We're afternoon. Are you night or afternoon?
I think we're afternoon.
I kind of like to – you're 140. We're 305. Baseball screwed me. The weather screwed me. We weren't supposed to play today. I've got golf on the schedule today. And so,
I'll
probably get home about fifth inning.
Mm-hmm.
Fifth inning. We have not played well in Philly of late, in case you didn't know. So, we'll see.
Let's take a break. We'll come back. Maybe offer up some advice.
I think
it's
we're due for
regular.
Some. Yeah, we're due for some. The last couple of weeks, one or the other hadn't been here. We're at TPC 1 week, and, inquiring minds want to know, can we straighten out the First Coast? It's a harder challenge than we knew when we started this segment. So that is coming up next, brought to you by Pet Paradise. It's a GFL Friday on 1010XL.
And initiate sequence.
1010XL.
1010XL.
1010XL. The drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
One of life's most important decisions if you're 18 years or older, you just got married, you just got divorced, you got kids. Of course you want to take care of your family. That's why I'm here to tell you about Matt Hinson and the Hinson Law Firm. Matt is the attorney, I'm not. But I've got a question that I know the answer to for most of you. Have you done your last will? And you're probably saying, no, Hick, I haven't done that. Well, you need to. Why? For a number of reasons. First off, you want to decide where your assets go, right, to the people that you choose. Planning also helps minimize income, gift, and estate taxes. Matt Hinson's your guy. He's going to listen. He's going to help you with some tough decisions. He's going to provide you info needed so you're at ease with your choice. It's a Hinson Law Firm. You got questions, reach out to Maddie. He's got the answers. 904-527-1700. That's 527-1700. Offices are in Jacksonville, Florida. You don't let the state decide your fate.
Men, are you suffering from erectile dysfunction or PE? The medical providers at Prime Men's Medical Center offer breakthrough treatments that eliminate problems in the bedroom without pain or surgery. 98% of men see instant results on their first office visit. Listen to a specialist in men's health.
I'm Dr. Simovitz. Prime Men's Medical Center offers breakthrough medical treatments that eliminate ED and PE. Men are even lasting 90 minutes or longer, regardless of age or medical history.
But that's not all. For a limited time only, call Prime Men's Medical Center now and your initial consultation and first treatment are completely free. You'll see instant results right in the office. You'll even get a gift that enhances your performance in the bedroom. All this, worth hundreds of dollars, is free if you call now. 904-664-8217. 904-664-8217. That's 904-664-8217.
Top Dog Tavern is your gathering place for family and friends, offering something for everyone. Want a delicious meal served with a smile? We have you covered. Shareable appetizers, hot and crispy wings, juicy tavern burgers, fresh salads, plus a large craft beer selection. And there is nowhere better to watch all the big games than on our multiple TVs. Enjoy great food, cold drinks, and good times at Top Dog Tavern.
located in Bartram Park off Old St. Augustine Road.
Hey, Hicken here. You know I'm a hometown guy. There's nothing like home in Jacksonville, Florida. What a great place to live. Spring is here and everything is green and blooming. But that means I'll have to cut the lawn soon. It also means that we'll need to do some deep cleaning inside the house. That's where Zero Res comes in. Zero Res can clean your tile and grout, the carpets, your area rug, furniture, and more. Right now, they're offering 25% off tile and grout cleaning. Zero Res, man, spelling forwards or backwards. The right way to clean.
Zero Res. Discover the difference that local expertise makes at First Coast Lighting and Fans. Visit their showroom at the Avenues and browse high-quality products to match your desire for elegance, quality, and uniqueness at First Coast Lighting and Fans.
Get closer to nature.
I'm Jeff Logman with Captain Kevin and Captain Kirk. We take you from the water to the woods.
The Nimnicht Outdoor Show, presented by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing and Septic Services. 7 to 10 every Saturday morning on 1010XL.
Discover the timeless beauty of stone with Art of Natural Stone, offering an extensive selection of products. They cater to every design aesthetic. And not just a supplier, they also provide the installation. Skilled craftsmen ensure a flawless finish every time with Art of Natural Stone. You receive not just a product, but an inviting welcome home experience. So embrace the elegance of your own yard this year with artofnaturalstone.com. Open to the public on Phillips Highway and on Beach Boulevard.
Have you or someone you care about been arrested or had their driver's license taken away? I'm Susan Cohen, and I work with David Robbins at the law firm of Epstein & Robbins. We are experienced fighters for those charged with DUI and all criminal offenses. I've been named the best DUI attorney in the state, and David has been named the best criminal defense lawyer in Jacksonville. In your battle with the justice system, there is only one thing you need to know. Dial David 24/7 at Epstein & Robbins, 354-5645.
We're in Florida, and pest problems are persistent. Want them gone? Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions. Veteran and locally owned and operated, Mission Pest will blow your mind with their communication and response time for all your pest, termite, and mosquito needs. Text or call 904-944-PEST. You'll speak directly with the owners. Mention 1010XL when you call 944-PEST. You'll get 25% off your initial pest or termite protection service. Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's lucky contestant, a cheese negotiator from Jacksonville, Florida, meet Margaret Drent.
How do you like my costume, Bob? I'm Gruyere.
Well, you smell great, Margaret. But here's your question. What's wrong with your air conditioner when you hear this sound?
Oh, that's a toughie. Are you sure you don't want me to tell you the suggested retail price of a box of Rice-A-Roni?
5 seconds, Margaret.
Is it a compressor motor starter failure?
That's right, Margaret. And if you call the coolness experts at Mueller Air Conditioning, we can fix that faulty AC to make sure that
you are cool.
Surprisingly stuffy inside a giant cheese.
You signed the waiver, Margaret.
Stay cooler with Mueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Beards Diamonds' most popular sale is back.
All wedding bands are buy one, get one free.
Plus, all stackables, all right-hand rings, all eternity bands, and more are buy one, get one free.
At the St. John's Town Center or at BeardsDiamonds.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Take it for a walk.
Gonna find my baby, gonna hold her tight, gonna grab some afternoon delight. My motto's always been, when it's right, it's right, while waiting till the middle of the cold, dark night. When everything's a little glimmer in the light of day, and we know the night is almost gonna be there anyway.
Take it away. Take it away.
I always wondered back in the day, we used to end the show with Afternoon Delight, and the Googans always thought it was us singing, and it was the dudes from Anchorman is the way we would play it, not the official Starlight, what is it, Vocal Band? Mm-hmm. But this, see, that's what it would sound like if it were actually yes. Yeah.
It's only right. It's Good Friday.
It is Good Friday.
It is, and a happy Easter, everyone. Appreciate, listen, to all of you that, you know, you cheesters, we like to call you, who'll be at church maybe for the second time and last time this year. Maybe it'll take this year. You'll be back next week. Here's hoping.
Mm.
Is it time to dole out some advice? Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay, listen, Dear Drill, we call it. We got issues out here on the First Coast, and by the way, we didn't know how. Well, we did. Of course we did. We know they're there. We're here to help with the best advice we can possibly give. We span a variety of demographics and age and ethnicity and everything, so we are going to give you our lock-solid best advice that we can. It's brought to you by Pet Paradise. Pet Paradise, spread the word. Nobody taking care of your pet better than our friends at Pet Paradise, who love them like you do. So from the very best in veterinary care with New Day Veterinary Care, to grooming, to overnights, to play dates, from the bone-shaped pool to the climate control suites, any and everything your pet's heart desires is there at Pet Paradise.
This comes to us from the South Side.
Oh.
That's all it says. It says, Dear Drill, man, I have a friend who talks nonstop. Honestly, I can't put the phone down and go make a cup of tea. She'll be talking when I get back. I don't think she even takes a breath. I want to tell her sometimes she needs to ask questions or seek opinions of others. How can I do this without hurting her feelings? She has many good qualities. Knowledgeable on many topics. She's artistic. Good cook. Just exhausting to be around. I feel bad for her husband. Her children are great. Good, productive citizens. But man, oh man. I dread getting calls from her.
What's his relationship to her?
Friend who talks nonstop.
Get new friends.
Oh?
Your friends, you're your friends because you enjoy their company and what they do and their interests. That sounds like she annoys the stew out of you. So separate yourself from this friendship because she needs somebody that likes to listen.
And you don't.
Mm-hmm. Me?
And she's annoying. I can tell. I can tell by your voice. So let somebody else enjoy all those good qualities because that one bad one's too much for you, my friend.
A wise man once said...
Yes, sir.
Shut the F up.
And, you know, sometimes you just got to hit him with that.
Okay.
Which will probably end the friendship, but yeah, that's similar advice.
Dear Drill, this comes over from the West Side.
West Side.
Yeah. Hubby and I are planning a cruise to celebrate our 30th wedding anniversary.
Okay.
As well as his retirement next year.
All right.
Older Googans. We invited my brother and his wife to join us. My brother always wanted to visit our cruise destination. They said sure. Well, then his wife shared our cruise plans with her brother and his wife.
Okay.
Once removed, so you see.
Mm-hmm.
That wife expressed interest in the destination and said she wants to go. So she was then welcomed to join us by the wife of my brother.
Mm-hmm.
When I was told this, I was like, well, wait a minute. They don't like cruises. Still, I'm annoyed at her presumptuousness. Am I wrong to feel the way I do about her inviting her family without first asking if it's okay with me and my husband? She did say she was sorry for inviting them, but I'm still annoyed. I love my brother and sister-in-law. I hate to cause family drama. What are your thoughts?
Unless your last name is Carnival or Norwegian or Royal Caribbean, ST, blake up, man. Shut up.
Okay.
What, do you control the itinerary now? If you don't want anyone to come, then don't invite your brother. Or when you invite your brother, say, hey, this is a special time for us. We don't want a big event, but would you two like to come? If you don't, you know, what do they think suddenly that this just in, you don't bunk together on a cruise, Hick?
Mm-hmm.
And, stop it. If you want to do something special, then keep it special. If you want to invite somebody, then make sure you tell them that, my God, on the 5,000-person cruise, nobody else we know can come. This isn't a wedding or something intimate that they crashed. It's a cruise. So,
okay,
I don't have a problem with it.
E?
Oh, the privilege. As Jeff was saying, is your last name Carnival or Norwegian? They go wherever they want. Stop tripping. Karen.
Oh, dear.
Carl.
Wow. Do we have time for one more? I think
Let's
we do.
Let's do it.
Dear Drill. This is from the beaches, by the way.
Okay.
The beaches.
I'm a single guy.
Okay.
Recently turned 40.
Ooh.
I'm looking to find a wife who, like myself, has never been married and has no kids.
Good luck.
I joined several dating websites, but most of the women are divorced or widowed or have kids.
I just discovered
a new dating website for single, never married people. I'm not sure if I should join it, but having a website designed for people like this is a great idea. I've read that 25% of all Americans have never been married. A research company just reported a brand new poll, and millions of Americans have never been married, so I am not losing hope. Should I join? This is from Andy Stitzer.
That sounds like that would come from a dude named Andy Stitzer.
You don't know who Andy Stitzer is?
No.
That was Steve Carell's name, the 40-year-old virgin. 40-year-old.
I feel for you, dude. Yes, join. Yes, and good luck. Join the dating site. Good luck finding this.
Is he limiting himself to two?
Limiting himself? He's 40 and he can't go out on a date.
He wants a woman who's never been married, has no kids.
Well, no.
She's roughly going to be anywhere from 30 to 50.
Yeah, stand by your guns. No. You're already 40. You're trying to find something. It'll be hard to find that, but maybe. Look, here's the reality. This hits in our demo. When you get to be our age, you're not going to find Miss Perfect, bro. We all got baggage at this point, E. So when you get to 40 years old, I would say, hopefully, as you meet, I think this could change. In your mind, you may say, I want a girl that's never been married, no kids. And you get on the dating site and you meet a variety of women, and there might be a couple that don't fall into that, but you really dig, and you'll find out, well, that's not the be-all, end-all requirement for you.
So what it sounds like to me is like this is a clear case of you need to lower your standards, my boy. You want somebody who ain't never been married, ain't never have kids. You about to get on a social media platform, man? Guess what?
Have fun sucking, then.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, this is kind of a nerd. It sounds like, man. He doesn't have a lot of skill. He doesn't have a lot of game. And so the question was, should I get on the dating site?
Yes.
As fast as you can.
Absolutely.
We've got
and pay the premium. Get the premium one too.
Got a little breaking news.
Yeah,
here.
We do.
We had the break. The Jaguars are signing linebacker Foye Oluokun to a 3-year contract extension, according to Adam Schefter.
Schefter. Yes.
Okay. He's gray.
He has jaundice, yes. Clinical jaundice. Adult clinical jaundice.
4 years, $45 million. Max value up to $48 million. 22.5 guaranteed at signing.
Foye is a good player. Let's keep our good ones.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Probably familiar with Ryan Nielsen. I'm assuming
4-3 defense, middle guy.
Good just tackling machine. He's dependable, reliable. He was never injured. Yeah, I like this. Let's get our money in line and go. And by the way, with each one of these extensions and this, Josh Allen sitting there like scratching his head. Like, what now? Wait, what? All right.
Right.
You can't not sign, you know.
That's Deer Drill.
Yeah.
Brought to you by Pet Paradise. Don't fall for the imitators. You go with the innovator. The guys that are the gold standard for the pet spa treatment, it's Pet Paradise and PetParadise.com.
The Drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
There are many ways to experience 1010XL.
The key to this whole thing is their computer.
Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube.
Get me that computer program.
Yes, sir.
At 1010XL.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Are you tired of having a plain and boring backyard? Really want to impress your family and friends this year? Then stop by Stone Core on Phillips Highway. Imagine hosting guests at your new outdoor kitchen, relaxing by your custom-built fireplace under a brand new pergola. Stone Core can also remodel your old pool deck and beautiful new pavers. Make your backyard wishes a reality. Visit Stone Core on Phillips Highway and let's get started at stonecore.co. We do outdoors better.
Are you 18 years or older, just got married, just got divorced, or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700, offices Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
If your ride is making strange noises, don't wait and make it worse. Come to Action Transmission on Merrill Road. My expert technicians can diagnose the problem and likely fix it fast. Experience the difference at Action Transmission on Merrill Road.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On March 29, 1982, UNC beats Georgetown in the NCAA Men's Tournament. Future Hall of Famer James Worthy is MVP.
Hey, this is Stevie Beechurst of Beechurst Plumbing. Growing up in Jacksonville, I was always proud when my dad would point at a building and say, "I did the plumbing for that." That's the same kind of pride we instill in every plumber here at Beechurst Plumbing. And that's the kind of pride you can expect when you hire Beechurst Plumbing for your home or business. Right now, we're doing New Year's specials to get your project going. To find out how we can help you, visit BeechurstPlumbing.com. BeechurstPlumbing.com. Beechurst Plumbing, here to help.
I'm here with Clayton Bromberg of Underwood Jewelers. Clayton, you spend a lot of time talking about diamonds, but what about some of the colored stones we see?
Frank, when you talk about colored stones, there are literally hundreds of varieties and species in the gem kingdom. As certified gemologists, we're trained gemologically on the identification of each of these and can separate the man-made synthetics and imitations from the real thing. But at Underwoods, we can go to the next step. At Underwoods, we're active buyers of loose colored stones in the world markets, so we have an understanding of the values of colored stones as they relate back to the various qualities. In fact, just like diamonds, we buy most of our colored stones loose, then create the pieces of jewelry to hold the gems. You can be assured not only of the authenticity and quality of our colored stone jewelry, but also of the value. So if you're in the market for a fine quality emerald, sapphire, ruby, aquamarine, amethyst, citrine, tourmaline, peridot, or any other gemstone, come by and see us at Underwoods.
From happy hour to late night fun, Anheuser-Busch wants to remind you it's better to take it easy and be in for the win. That means you had a good time and you got home safely. So know when to say when and be there for the next big time by designating a driver.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
David Lane here again for Southeast Orthopedic Specialist. After several surgeries for age-old issues, mainly my back and shoulders, there's no doubt that Southeast Orthopedic Specialist is my sustaining resource for living pain-free. Take it from me, and I'm being really honest here, there's no better orthopedic facility here in Jacksonville.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
Get ready to rock your evening with the band Be Easy at Players Grill Mandarin, a high-energy, multi-genre cover band from classic hits to chart toppers. See you at Players Grill Mandarin Friday, April 5th at 8 p.m. Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Tony, are you interested in the Mets starting lineup for today? I have it right here in front of me.
No,
the one that's going to carry us to the championship.
Yeah, I can go through my day without knowing
okay.
the lineup.
Well, just so you know.
I'll watch a little bit of whatever the Mets got going on.
We go early today. We go 1:40. You go later.
Yeah, so look, I am the guy that, you know, yesterday when baseball hit the television at 3 o'clock.
Yeah.
From 3 o'clock until it was time to close my eyes and go to sleep, I had baseball on.
I enjoy it, too. Foye Luikon gets a new deal. Thoughts?
Good for Foye.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we'll see what the repercussions are, you know, for the rest of it. He had 1 year left on the deal, so it was, what's that going to look like going into the future? Well, now we don't have to ask that question. What does it mean for Devin Lloyd? You know? Yeah. And, you know, how secure his spot is on the roster beyond the next couple of seasons, potentially. You know, what exactly does that look like? I don't know, but we know how much they have been willing to invest at linebacker, even inside linebacker. And, you know, looking it up, Foye got the deal today, and he's going to get something around $11.5 million a year, right, is what he's going to get. He'd be the fifth inside linebacker in the league to be averaging $10 million or more a year.
All right, what do you guys got cooking today on a Jaguars Today Friday?
Our question of the day today, asking, assuming Christian Kirk and Evan Engram are the top two targets for Trevor Lawrence this year, who will end up being the Jags' next most impactful pass catcher? Your options, Gabe Davis, Travis Etienne, Zay Jones, or a rookie draft pick for the team this year, and we'll have Tom McManison reacting to
the
week-long news for the Jacksonville Jaguars.
All right, well, it should be a great show. Looking forward to it. Thank you, Tony. Jaguars Today coming up momentarily. So get ready to rock and roll from 10 to noon. Jeffrey.
We talk about karma a lot in sports, right? I mean, like sports fans, we're big on karma, and this occurs to me as I head into the weekend. I need to ride a program.
Mm-hmm.
Like I've never ridden, but I need to hold on like death around the neck of the horse that is the Tennessee Volunteers basketball program.
Now you're reaching out to a program that you have annihilated.
That's correct. So karma, I'm literally counting on a program that we will Tootlem joins us from Pigeon Forge. Yeah!
Volcom!
How's this going to work?
Should have had an extra episode of Volcoms today.
We should have.
We will Monday.
You could have went, now Cletus, hold on a second now. Hold on.
We will on Monday. I'm just curious, how did they bounce them footballs? They seem an odd shape.
Ball Roll Tide!
All right, well, we shall see.
He's the leader at 55. Dan's got 49. Jeff's got 40 heading into tonight.
It's very, very possible. In fact, it's probably likely that come Monday, it'll be all
right. It won't be all right.
I'm going to be, coming up with the categories. And I'd rather just, I'll do it Tuesday. I don't give a damn. Let's get it over with.
Ooh.
I don't need it lingering over me.
Wow.
I mean, if I've officially lost.
Yeah.
I'm not going to do it if I haven't lost, but I'm just predicting my demise. What I need to happen ain't happening. And at the end of the day, here's how it will work for me, Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Tennessee will win.
Yeah.
They will go to the Final Four. They will be Purdue. Houston will win. They will go to the Final Four. It'll be Houston and UConn. If Houston wins, I escape. Final score, UConn 94, Houston 77. This is the drill at GFL Friday.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll have...